men don't even use protection. I hate stupid shit ass hoes can't avoid. Yo, and if worse came to worse, I run a portal unemployed. Cause who the fuck cares that I got gray hairs and can't sleep? Know what I mean?
Hell yeah.
This is deep. I'm going deep.
The views, comments, and opinions of the following program do not necessarily reflect those of Morris Media Studios, MorrisMediaLive.com, or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Can you hear me?
Anyway. It'll be like, oh, we was gonna pay, but oh shoot, I think we
are we on? Are we on?
Oh shit, we on again.
Just never, as always, and that's yeah. All right, I'm Lewis Dix.
I'm Dannon Green.
Now, obviously.
Well, now can you hear me? I'm here.
Okay, Jeff is zooming in again. I guess he thinks he thinks people still want to see his house.
Yeah, see, I knew better than to zoom in 2 weeks in a row.
Yeah, and TDP's on
his way. No, this is. You remember these days, Lewis, when you was a homeowner? This is what you got to deal with.
Why does he look homeless?
What? What
he looks like
so you're doing work. So you, okay. All right. Okay. I think he went to other people's homes and pulled that tree.
So everybody can look bad for him.
Yeah, and then put it in front of his house.
Jeff's working hard. Look at him.
I mean, I don't know what.
You remember? You remember these days?
I don't know what persona you're trying to project, but just 1 second. It's funny how the people in the world will believe that.
Yeah.
So we'll let you.
Because that's sure enough ain't no treat. I mean, that much in one spot? Yeah, he put that shit there.
Yeah, so, I mean, come on. Yeah, it didn't just blow in one spot.
Yeah.
So, okay. All right, hold up. I just wanted. I get a little frustrated.
You remember these days when you had two homes? You remember, right?
I don't know what you're trying to, what joke you're trying to get. Or
why are you jabbing at you over a home, man?
Hey, you know,
man,
the fact of the matter is, it doesn't bother me.
Yeah.
because
he got a lot of shit to do right now.
And plus, I had people to do that for me.
So Jeff, you could have been here. Jeff, you could have got Pablo and Francisco to go ahead and hook it up.
He could have got Jerome and Andre too.
No, they would have robbed him.
If I had my two friends, I could have had Dannon and Lewis come help me.
No, we're not doing it. If we'll pick up a mic for you.
Shoot, I'll come and help you. You'd be missing something out the crib. All
right. From his bar, huh?
Yeah, from the bar. The rum. Oh, your wine bar.
TDP said he's running late. I don't understand why. He had, and I texted him back, he had all day to be on time.
I've been here.
Yeah, you know, that's the thing. Why, and I'm going to be... Like he says, I'm always generalizing. Why are black people, why are we always late?
Well, I'm happy you said it, because if I would have said it, the chat room would have called me a coon. So
I mean, we are.
We're late. We don't have any responsibility. And then we're going to blame it on the white man.
I mean, we're always late. I mean, even for something that's important to us, we're late. And we always got a reason.
I got an excuse.
You know, because in sports and coaching thing, if you're on time, you're late.
You're late. If you're not 15 to a half an hour early, you're late.
Yeah, especially in show business, too. You can't show up on time.
When you book
something, you have to show up on time.
You do. When you book something, like you book a commercial, you know about the book, really commercial, but definitely, they'll call you. Your call time will be 7:30 in the morning. You may not shoot until 10:30, 11.
Right.
But at 6:37, when they say you're supposed to be here, there'll be someone saying, hey, anybody, any eyes on Louis Dix? Any eyes on Lou?
Right.
Even though you may not shoot for 2 or 3 hours
right.
late.
I got a show Saturday. The show starts at 5. My call time is 2.
Exactly.
Two.
And you ain't going to be doing nothing.
Right. But you just got to prepare yourself mentally and be ready.
And be ready. You should not be coming. Yeah.
It's just.
Especially, look. When I can't make it, it's because, like, I have car trouble. But I live in the valley.
Right.
I'm 20, 30 miles from the joint.
Right.
You know what I mean? So at least, you know, so, man, if you live in L.A., you should be here, TDP.
And that's just the thing. Oh, wow. I mean, I'm sure we're not the only ones.
Well, no. Jeff, you too, Jeff. You live right around
the corner. I'm always on time.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. I'm 30 minutes. I'm so professional. When I have a job and I book a job, I'm there at least an hour before.
So why are you late here to the show?
Well, we have no respect for this show.
Oh, my bad. I'm sorry.
No,
TDP is actually on time then.
No,
I mean, the boss lady is always here.
She is always here.
She was.
And I called in an hour earlier and told her.
She did.
So, yeah.
I can't. See, I'll come down and go to Chef Merlin's and give me a plate, and then I'll come here and eat and enjoy myself, my meal with her cat. And then I'll come in here.
That's hilarious. Oh, you is that should too stop. Much? No, oh. You know, I'm saying he should stop. Well, you could because you're a cat person now.
Yeah, I'm a cat man now.
Do you relate more to her cat now?
No, but when I see her cat, like I asked her a question about the cat today because the cat was sitting there. I was like, you know, how old was your cat? She said, 3. I'm like, damn, that's a big ass cat. He must be eating outside food. But she said, no, he's a male. I said, oh.
Now,
I got
a
female.
How does she know how old the cat is? She just met the cat.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, she doesn't know how old. I mean, she.
Oh, he was a stray cat, huh?
Yeah, you don't know.
The cat.
He was here when he was a baby kitten. So he's been here 3 years. So he's 3 years old.
Plus, at least.
He's a Nigerian cat. He's lying. He's really 19.
Have you named the cat?
Yeah, his name
is Charlie.
Now, does he know that?
Yeah, I can call and be like, I call him Baby Charlie.
But you don't take. Oh. You leave him here.
Yeah, he's a stray. He runs the streets, and so at night, he comes here when he's hungry.
So when at night he's out. A pimp. So he doesn't stay inside.
No.
See, my cats are different. If I pick my cat up and start walking towards the front door, man, that motherfucker lose her mind. She start looking around first because she like she don't know where I'm carrying her. Man, I open up that front door, claws come out. All right, nigga, put me down.
She don't want to leave.
She don't like the outside, and I think maybe it might be her owner before because she knew every time when she went out. She landed with me, so I guess maybe she's like, I don't know where this nigga taking me.
Kind of like your dog joke.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, boss, the cat comes inside when you're here?
Yeah, sometimes he'll come in, kick it in here.
Now, have you ever
I'm sitting in here.
Tried to leave him in here overnight?
By accident.
Oh, you mean you locked him in?
One time when we were, when he got injured, remember when the bird attacked him?
Look at his ass whipped by the bird out there fucking around at night.
We kept him in here for about a week.
God, he was in the jungle.
Because he was, you know, under antibiotics.
Poetess, so I noticed, I haven't seen any. So is he straight to the point where you don't even have a litter box for him in here?
No.
So he is straight?
He's a straight.
Oh, he ain't but a pimp.
But I saw you just outside coming in. Were you feeding him?
Yeah.
So you keep his food in a box or something?
Yeah, well, we keep food in there for him, and when he comes, we just put in his
dish. Can you pick him up?
Yeah.
You can? So he doesn't try to scratch you anything?
Nope.
I'm not going to try to.
Because he's been with me since he was a kitten.
So in his mind, he's asking, why don't you just take him to the crib?
Because I already have Morris there, and I can't have two cats.
Morris. Oh, you got, so you have a cat at home?
Yes.
I never
you
knew
named
that.
Him after your business.
Yeah, and Morris was here, too, for about 4 years before I took him to my house.
So Morris was here first, so that's why he got the crib?
He got the crib because he got injured too.
Man, you got some cats. Yeah, your cats out here. Well, they do live in, off of Crenshaw.
And so I just, after I took him to the vet, I just took him home.
She got gang cats.
Yeah.
No,
but Charlie stays here at the studio and he runs the streets and he comes here a couple times a day.
All right, so Charlie
be in the street talking shit. I mean, what y'all doing tomorrow? Y'all want to come out
Charlie
with some food?
Be out there.
Pimping hoes.
Charlie be playing. Yeah.
Slanging dick around it. Chris Shaw.
He ran up on the wrong bird.
Yeah, he did. Trying to bang the bird.
That bird fucked his paw up.
Now he handicapped. So he parked in the handicapped spot.
Hilarious.
Okay, cool.
I got to leave out. I have an emergency at the Dime, so I hit y'all later.
The Dime? What's that?
That's my bar. Business.
I know. I was trying to give you some juice. See, I threw the nigga a lob and he had attitude. He supposed to say, "No, that's the bar I own." Blah blah blah.
I love when TDP said, "What are you in a wheelchair?" The way he was walking. You don't know how to. You need to get with a young person to tell you how to show you how to do that.
Yeah.
Because you don't know how to walk in.
Jeff and trim your beard down, man. You looking 70.
He looks like Dr. J. Is that no?
No, please.
What's the other
please?
One?
Bill Russell.
Somebody told him. Evidently, some woman told him, well, his wife told me he looked sexy. That's what that is.
Oh, is that what it is?
When someone tells you that.
Code 3.
But wait, I was showing the video.
He said Code 3.
She did not say that.
I was showing the show to a friend. We were riding and I had the show on and she was like, "Ooh, he's cute. Talk about Jeff."
Oh, she wasn't talking about me?
No.
I don't understand. No. I don't understand. Somebody said the earring was sexy. I don't know. Nose.
Some dude named Larry.
The nose ring.
Yeah.
Some dude named Mike.
I got to go, but hey, Sydney want to say hi to you.
Yeah, that joke is so old. That's not even an urn. That's too big for an urn.
Yeah.
Okay, and Sydney's urn.
Especially a baby.
So, yeah, that's just a weak joke. Sydney's urn is a lot smaller.
I don't fall for the trap. Good luck at the Dime.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Good luck to clean up. Yeah. Take those same trees that fell off in front of the Dime.
Yeah.
Oh, hilarious.
Yeah.
Well, you should, as a friend, you should help me.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the guy.
I had
just
your sweatshirt too, but they had 3X, and I know you don't. I don't know if you can.
Knock a rock that. I just get
Where's
a,
my
I get
sweatsuit? I don't never get no gifts.
Well, I just asked Coach.
Didn't he give you a pair of Adidas for Christmas?
That he gave everybody?
Yeah, you know those shoes? I looked them up. They're worth some money.
Are they? I haven't worn them yet.
Yeah.
Can I trade them in?
Oh, are they worth something?
What they worth?
They are. I'm trading mine in because they don't fit.
Where did you get them?
And they're ugly to me.
Where you trade them in? I mean, where do you take them? Where you going to take yours?
Somewhere online. Right. Where they sell.
Well, let me
where
know.
They sell Snickers.
I've never worn them.
Snickers.
Snickers.
Yeah. My son did his sold his.
How much he sold for?
I don't know.
I seen him online like for $500.
Oh yeah. Shit. I'm gonna say I don't like to do that to people when they give me a gift, but bye.
Yeah.
500. Did you open up the pack though?
Yeah, because I was gonna see if they fit, but then I was like,
so will they still sell? Because sometimes if it's
they have never been worn, they're still in the package.
Right, I've never worn them either. No, I was just wondering. I'm just saying, you know, the silver pack thing that it was in.
Can you open the gate for the late guy? So you know, and that's the thing too. Okay, now people have been asking me, and I don't know if people in the chat room. Hello, the people in the chat room.
What's up, chat room?
In the comment,
Corey, what's his name? Corey, what's up, man? I'm back. Corey hates when I'm here. He go, "Oh, Danny here again."
Corey.
Some dude in the chat room. I'm going to give him some love. But I want to thank some of those people that have been giving me love. I think somebody gave me real love last week and said I was right about a couple things. So thank you. But Corey, thanks for listening, man. Appreciate you. Even if you go at me.
You people in the comments, you do what you do. And I'm cool with it.
I'm cool with it, too.
But look, he's been wearing this mask.
Yeah, what's up with the mask, man? Is he missing a tooth?
You know, it's interesting because people have been trying to figure out what it is.
Like, I don't know, you know.
If someone, one of my friends says.
He's at the gate.
One of my friends said it must be a dental thing.
Right.
That he's missing some teeth. I thought that was. Oh, he doesn't have the.
Oh, he must have went to the dentist over the weekend. Okay. Damn, okay. All right. He ain't got it on. Damn.
Right. I'm glad because I was going.
He's going to have to.
I was going.
Now, why are you coming like a grandfather? Going to kiss her on the forehead like she all that?
I was going to say. I was going to ask. I was like, I'm tired of this mess thing. I'm going to ask him. He's putting it back on. Now, because. All right. Because Jeff said. He can't. Jeff just called in.
Oh, no, he's Jeff putting it
said,
on.
Is his teeth okay?
I think he missed one.
Jeff said he had the Michael Jackson stuff going on.
Oh, the Clemba, what do they call it?
I don't know. What is that stuff called when you
white man turning?
Yeah, you're turning. And I was like, all right, nah, maybe. But then we would have saw spots
but
of that.
The thing about it happened so abruptly. It was like, one, he's no mask. Next thing you know, he masked. And then his attitude got worse when he had the mask. He cursed you out more.
And man, I'm like, well, I was like, all right, he going through something.
Yeah, he got some issues.
Maybe he got some warrants or something.
Look at him coming out. How you going to be late and you going to bring liquor to the party?
I know he did. Ugh, so man, I was trying to figure out. I was going to go with the tooth thing.
I think it's the tooth.
You know, but he walked in without it.
TDP, what up?
He looks clean shaven.
He's clean, and the hat's nice. Got a clean white hat on.
So he looks like he finally got a shower in.
Okay. Got the little Columbia jacket on.
So, yeah, that looks new.
That's new.
Yeah, it's new.
Hands are clean.
That's new.
Don't touch me.
Yeah, he's dusty for a minute.
Must have been bathing over the weekend.
Yeah, he had an Eddie Murphy bath.
Got the Eddie
Coming to America.
Yeah, got the little snow bunnies washing his balls.
Okay, let's see. All right, so no, his skin is the same.
Okay,
color.
There's two glasses. Who's not getting one?
No, I got tea. I got.
Oh, okay.
Code 3 made me some tea.
Do you have any Coca-Cola? Okay.
Real men drink it straight.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go with this real man bullshit. Coming That's my real man on the corner with no liver. Real man. Smart man mix it up. Dilute their pain. Thank you.
That's funny. Real man. Real man.
Gentlemen. It's good to see you gentlemen again, TDP.
Cheers.
Cheers.
There you go to Jeff.
Jeff called in
early.
He was on his, he has to go, he had to show us outside of his crib, had some issues, and then he had to go to the dime. His bar.
He had one leaf fall. This motherfucker had to call in.
All right, let me take. All right, you tell me how you. All right. Your friend calls you. All right, so Jeff calls me and says, "Hey man, what do you think about selling some hot dogs? Or having some hot dogs? It's hot dogs. So I'm thinking, are you on barbecue? Something in my brain.
Are you grilling?
What holidays coming up? Yeah. So he says, no, at the dime. He wants to have a hot dog stand and sell the hot dogs to the people, you know, I guess at night.
Right.
So, you know, he said, man, I'll buy the hot dogs. I get to stand in it, and I just need you to serve them.
Oh, so you the slave.
So I'm like, he said, we can go partners. And I'm like.
Hot dogs ain't.
I'm like, well, you got to get a food license first. Yeah. I'll do all that. I get all that. So.
Well,
all
right. How do Mexicans get all that? They on every corner.
No,
they got a license.
All right,
anybody harassing them?
All those Mexicans outside the liquor game, they got license. They showed me.
Oh, okay. So I was just thinking. At first, I was like, "Okay, I hear you." Then you know your ego jump in. Like, all right, I'm at the club. Yo, Lou Dix. I'm selling.
You are there calling to holler at the honey? Hey, girls, hey, yo, Lou.
Now, yo, man, isn't that the comedian the one say you selling hot dogs now?
Oh yeah, you need a dog.
And do your act.
Now I've worked in N's kitchen.
Yes, you have.
Yeah, you have.
JJ Anthony Brown's kitchen.
You have.
Out.
And I yes, have to you say, have. You were great at N's. You were great at the comedy.
I would
union.
Go up, then I'd go in the back in the kitchen for us.
And people
chicken.
Would be like, "Ain't that the nigga that just gave me the chicken?"
Yeah.
Yo, you funny.
No, I never served. I was just in the back.
Okay.
So just the comedians would come back, and young boys like, "Oh, he done. His career over."
Yeah. This nigga serving chicken.
You know. So, but hot dog stand from the dime.
Oh, not inside, in front?
Yeah, it'd have to be in front.
Oh, that's worse. I thought you'd at least be inside.
Right.
No, you don't want to do that one, Lou. You gotta have a little. You gotta have something about yourself.
Some pride.
Yeah.
I can't be in front. What do you?
Well, you can have the best hot dogs in town.
But it's got to be a younger comic that needs.
No, it's you. It's you.
I mean, I'll invest.
No, go on and get you $20 for a hot dog and then hire somebody to take over.
He said
job.
Hot dogs and chips. He's selling by $15 each.
$15 for us.
Nigga, what kind of hot dog y'all serving?
See?
Well, before we go on, we have to give Lou a big congratulation.
For what? What he do right. now wrong?
That's right.
Oh, y'all won? That's right. Oh, way to go, Lou.
That's right. That's right.
Wait, right. Why does that year say 22?
No, it's 22. I'm just messing with you. That's right. Sacramento.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
That was, now, it's a story behind that. Interesting story.
We're not interested in it.
Okay, that's cool, though.
Let's keep it moving.
I mean, you are back-to-back champ, so.
Yeah.
Is it the same story? Yeah, it is. And you said that story last time.
No, this is what happened in the arena.
Oh, what happened?
When we were going to watch the girls play. Right. And so it's the way we have to enter. And we hadn't got the team. I usually lead the team in and all that, make sure. So the athletic director's in there already. Now, this is a white boy in there, see, and two brothers and a sister.
Why are you pointing like they're here?
Well, I just want to see where they're sitting. So we walk in, and the team's not really.
Come to piano play.
The team is outside. So I walk in. So, you know, he sees my H-dub stuff, and he's like, first thing white says, excuse me. I'm like, excuse me. I'm going to bring the team in. So, oh, you guys got your passes last night. That's what the white guy says. I'm like, no, we didn't. I said, well, hey, all right. You know, another coach standing by me. So I said, okay, I don't think we did. So then he says, oh, no, you didn't get him. I'm sorry, yeah, you didn't get him. Okay. So the next thing he says, oh, but you guys are supposed to enter downstairs. You come in the back way.
Right, dude, right. Slave.
So I'm like, okay, but our athletic director says to meet him here. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, yeah, Matt's coming up.
That's okay, yeah, going through.
Third thing he says, well.
My rigmarole.
Yeah, so the third thing he says something else about you guys are not supposed to come in yet. Your game's not till 8:00. Mm-hmm. But yeah, but we're here to watch the girls. Somebody whispers in the ear. Oh, okay, yeah, you guys come in to watch the girls. So then he's about to say the fourth thing. I said, hold up, my man.
Yo, my man.
You've been wrong three times.
Yeah.
I said, come on, my man. You've been wrong three times.
Yeah. What don't you like about me?
Right, so you've been wrong three times. I said, now why don't you let one of them answer a question since you don't know what you're talking about?
Right.
Well, no, you got to, all right, well, this is what I do know. Mm. And he said something else, and it was wrong. I said, that's 0 for 4.
Damn.
I said, 0 for 4, my man. I said, because I see, now you're talking like a cop. You're trying to figure stuff out.
Right.
I said,
right.
So now,
trying to get you to snitch on yourself.
Then he started sulking. I said, now your feelings hurt. I said, come on, man.
Yeah.
Come on.
Just let us in.
I said, so, you know, then Matt comes up, and I was like, all right, here's the athletic director. I said, so now your feelings hurt, man. Mm. I said, come on, man, get out of your feelings, man. I said, yeah. Then the black guy's trying to laugh, but not really trying to laugh, right?
Like, he need a job.
And I said, my man, why are we acting like women? Mm. Why? I said, when did we get to a point where men can't talk? You wrong. You know you wrong. We move on. But now you got to be in your feelings. Get out of your feelings, man. That's what women used to do. We're men. Mm. All right? We're grown men here at a sporting event, and you acting like a woman. Mm-hmm. So now, Matt comes in, and the team goes in. I said, all right, go ahead. So then all of a sudden, he's over there talking to Matt. I said, now you're going to go over there and snitch and probably going to lie.
Right.
Now, the brothers is laughing because they know me. Hey, Lou, that was hard. You were right, man. That's how he is. They do that. That's how he is. Mm-hmm. And so then Matt comes over after talking to him. Lou, why? That's our chaperone for that. I said, yeah, he could be our chaperone, but he's wrong, Matt.
Yeah.
I said, now, come on now. Oh, Lou, he said one of the coaches was rude to him, and right away I knew it was you. I was like, man, I wasn't rude to him. He just was wrong. All right?
See, now I'm pissed off at the athletic director. See, that's where I would be getting, in trouble at. Because the athletic director knows you.
Right.
He knows you're not going to just come up and start some issue. So if you got four situations where this dude has done said something, and he's talking to him, I would be like, okay, let me talk to Lou. And I'd be like, Lou, I wouldn't even say nothing
But that's
to you.
How we know that's how they do.
Yeah.
So I know, but I know Matt's going to come back around. So I leave with the team. So then Matt comes back downstairs. Hey, Lou, you good? The black guy told me the real story. And you're all good. That guy was wrong, and you're all good.
You should have socked him in his eye when he said the black guy.
So, but that's just how he talks. I mean, I can, you know, that's how he talks. So then I see the brother ladies like, Lou, I got you, man. My man was trying to lie, and you said you was rude and all that. I had to straighten him out. And then the rest of the big good part, the rest of the day he had to, when we got there, because the only thing he could have done was for us to lose.
Right. So, that's the only joy he could have got
right
out
before
of
the game, because he was our escort going to when we were going to warm ups. Right. So he was telling the team, come on. And the team's like, no, we don't go to Coach Lou's here. So that messed him up. He's like, no, come on now. He said, no, sir. Coach Lou leads us out. So that messed him up right there. So he had to wait for me. All right, Coach, are you ready? Yeah, we're ready. Let's go. Mm-hmm. So then afterwards, he's like, okay, I need you guys to go to the media room now. He's like, we just told you We won. Coach Lou leads us to the media room.
My question is, he's just a chaperone. Where's all these orders coming from?
Because that's who he was. Yeah. He's, and like the brother said, that's what he's used to doing.
No, he's used to these white boys doing it. I mean, black people or whoever bowing down to him.
You're in that moment where you trying to keep your job. You ain't going to argue with the man. You want your job. They know him, so they know how to play him. Right. Somebody like me that doesn't know him, played him how he's going to be played.
Played him right.
So it's just, you know, and it made me think of the whole thing about why are men so sensitive, and are we more sensitive today?
Well, you just proved it.
Why, though?
Because they're soft.
But what type of sensitivity are you talking about, though?
I think we're sensitive about what I say. Yeah, I mean, it used to be a time where men accepted, all right, you're right, my fault, homie.
It take the loss and keep it pushing.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm not going to go tell. I'm not going to get upset. I'm not going to try to hurt you. I'm not going to try to go behind your back and snitch. I'm going to take the loss and keep it moving. I'm not going to go to another guy and say, just like I think sometimes as black people, we go to another brother that we think don't like you and say, yo, man, I don't like that man. Mm-hmm. And then that person is so weak, they agree. Right. As opposed to say, no.
I've had that situation, but the dude liked me. And he didn't know the dude liked me. Mm-hmm. Well, he didn't know the dude was my boy.
Right.
And he came back and told me.
Right.
I never said nothing to the dude. I just chalk it up as now I know how to deal with him.
So are you're not a guy to go say something. You're a guy
No, you know what? The only time I'm going to say something to somebody is if you go ahead and directly like spread something out there. But if you saying something to someone else and they come back and tell me, I'm not going to say nothing to you.
Yeah. You're just going to file that.
I'm going to file it. I don't have to. Now I know what you really feel about me. But if I go back and say something, I lose the trust with him.
What somebody say behind your back is none of your business.
Okay, that's how you feel.
That's how you handle it.
Okay. And but what if it affects you in certain ways?
That's
your
fault.
Because you've allowed that. So that means that's how you are not handling your other stuff.
Agreed.
Okay. Now that's interesting. I'd like to know people out there.
The only time I do it, this is what I do. Like, have you ever had it where someone come up, they'd be mad at somebody, and you know them, and they'd be like, yo, man, this motherfucker, man. And they know him, right? And I would say, look, you know I know him. He's my boy. I said, now you might be telling me this to get this off your chest so you can tell me. You know what I mean? I ain't going to say nothing to him. I said, nah, but if you tell me you're going to go fuck him up after this, you know I'm about to give him a call, let him know that this shit is about to break loose. You know what I mean? That's the only time. Yeah, you got to snitch to save his life.
Caller! Are you a snitch?
Hey, you see, that's the problem right there.
What? Damn, this nigga calling in?
He'll take all that shit, but you won't come sell hot dogs for me where you can be your own boss. Mm. See? You gotta go through that argument.
Yeah, I did not say
put a little bit more money in your pocket.
I did not say. So first of all, you jump into conclusion. I did not say I wouldn't do it. I was just putting it out on the table. Okay. I didn't say I wouldn't do it. I just said that.
No, your pride took it over.
I just admitted, but see, you didn't listen to the whole thing. I admitted that I fried chicken to Jay. I fried chicken at the end. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, if it came to that, then yeah, I would go ahead and do the hot dog stand. So I said that. See, your ego is jumping in.
Mm. Jeff, how much you paying?
Your ego is jumping in.
Jeff, how much you paying for that position?
That's why you got stopped as, you know, a coach. You know, he didn't recognize you.
That's why what?
That's why the same thing happened to Patrick Ewing when he was at the Garden and the motherfucker security stopped him. He didn't know who he was.
No, they were just fucking with Pat.
He didn't stop me. He was just wrong. He was in charge because I was walking to his event. So you're taking it. I approached him and said, what do we need to do? And he gave me four wrong answers. Right. And then he got corrected because I walked in and I walked out with a ring. Mm-hmm. So so you got to understand that. See, you thinking something else. Your ego's in the way about me with your hot dog stand.
Yeah, what you need to do is go break the leaves up.
Yeah, you need to go.
Not
you,
at all.
You need. Did you finish everything at the dime? Because that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to be handling an emergency.
Hey, Jeff, how much is the position pay?
How much is the position pay?
How much is it?
It's the comic seat, $20.
How long is the set?
It's okay.
Now, that's funny because you should have every comic that wants to get now should work a hot dog 4 hours.
It's a business.
Exactly.
Man.
Right.
I'll do it, Jeff.
Now, how do you get a license? That was one of the things we were trying to figure
out.
Yeah,
we got the little Mexican stand cracking.
Because you know they're going to jam us up.
Come on, man. I know the police around that way.
Everybody always say they know somebody. Yeah.
To the cop, because
payola out here, man.
But I have food trucks that stop out there too, so I mean it's cool. You're not gonna get stopped for anything. So I know what I'm doing.
Food truck pull up and I got the little hot dog stand. What they gonna go do?
The food truck got to get permission from me first, or they got to go down the block.
So you running the streets now?
Poetess felt that $15 was kind of
that's too low.
That's too expensive for a hot dog LA. And chips.
Yeah, for hot dog and chips.
Hold up, homie. Listen to me. When a motherfucker is intoxicated, they gonna pay that.
Thank you.
They gonna pay that. They gonna put that grease on that stomach to bring that high down. You acting like I don't know. I'm there every night. Exactly. I hear motherfuckers begging for food.
Jeff, I'll do it, Jeff.
When I did have a food truck come here, that person made a grip.
Right.
So I know what I'm doing.
What's going to be on the hot dogs? Is it going to just be hot dogs?
Yeah, mustard, ketchup.
Is it
going to
be relish, onions?
Wrap it in bacon?
Yeah, wrap it in bacon.
Because the Mexicans, they
you're greedy.
They got their stuff.
Yeah, the Mexicans, you know what? It's tasty.
Yeah, if they want all of that, that's going to be extra.
That's $30 right there.
Damn.
Exactly.
And you on a napkin? Come on, man.
Yes.
And does a bun come with it?
Yes.
Yeah, a warm bun.
That's stupid. Now, where are we going to store the...
Back, my plumber here. I'll meet you back,
man.
Late.
That's how Earl started. Absolutely. Earl's hot dogs down the street.
Yeah.
Now he has a restaurant.
So now we're gonna compete with Earl.
He used to be in front of every club back in the what was that, the '90s.
Earl used to be at birthday parties. He was right there with Tommy the Clown. He has a
stand. Yep, he has his hot dog stand right out in front of his restaurant now.
All right then.
So the way it sounds, Louis, everybody thinks you should become a hot dog maker.
I think, all right, here's my thing. I understand what he's saying.
Yeah. They have a bunch of clever names in the chat room for your hot dogs.
Oh, my God, already?
All right, what should
I'll
it be?
Say a few of them.
Lou Dick.
Dix's dogs. Dix, Franks, and Wieners.
That's a good one.
Cute.
Dix's Last Stand.
Oh, that's good. Hey. Buy my
Dick's
dick.
Buns. Dick's dogs.
Dick's dogs. All right. Well, we'll see the entrepreneur, Jeff. I just think we could get a younger person to serve it, an up and coming comic.
Okay. It won't be a good look for you. It won't be a good look.
I mean, now,
you need some help.
And I'm in the food. I know how to serve.
Yeah. Unless you guys were like partners, I don't know. He wouldn't be paying me to do it. We would have to partner or something. Like that.
Yeah, that's what he mentioned.
I could see Jeff doing this. He had to do it, taking IDs, and then somebody say to him, some woman, "Oh, who's that? Oh, this bitch ass nigga sells some hot dogs."
I can imagine Jeff. Hey, Lou, I need two of them now.
Yeah, yeah. Just get left.
Oh, you gonna get all of them?
Yeah.
I need two of them.
Lou,
my man. Hey, put more mustard on that, Lou.
Yo, yeah, yeah. Y'all good.
I'm going to have a call in, so be busy.
Tell him you got, Lou, give him two free ones. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I can see Jeff telling you, oh, man, you just looking stupid. And then that's the day the executive is driving down the street, ready to give you a show. And they go,
That's it. That's the show right there.
I don't know about
hot
that.
Hot dog on the stick.
Hot dog Lou.
Weenie and the man.
That's funny. All right, we'll give it a shot. Okay. Let's see how it goes. Let's give it a shot. All right.
Wait a minute. We could have Poetess on the weekends with a tube top. She can work Saturday.
Me serving water ice.
Yeah, he can employ all of us. All right, there you go, Jeff. There you go. Because he knows what he's doing. He always says that.
Absolutely.
I know what I'm doing. He always says that. Yeah. I know what I'm doing.
Even though he don't know.
He don't know what he's doing. I know what I'm doing.
Why he picked you though, out of all of everybody?
That's his friend.
Well, yeah, I guess he wanted me to partner up. He said, but he's
the
always.
The other day said hot dogs on a dick.
That's what I said.
Who said that?
That's cute. Kevin.
Hot dog Kevin.
Chat room. Hey,
hot
funny.
Dog on a dick.
All right, so the number is 323.
Can we get that meme?
Hilarious. 323-815-4204.
For what?
And just give us a call and let us know. We're going to go back on the sensitivity thing. If you...
Can we not?
Well, what are you sensitive about?
The topic.
I'm only sensitive about, y'all already know, family. I just don't talk. I don't like to bag on people's families. That's all right. Outside of that, I could take anything. I've been talked about all my life with my list, so that doesn't problem.
Hmm?
All right. Yeah, me it's
a problem for us.
Me it's when
there's a P in there somewhere.
Ain't that a bitch?
Community.
It's when someone says I'm not smart.
I'm not smart.
Yeah, if they say you dumb or you stupid, or you can't comprehend something, which is true a lot, but I'm still sensitive about it.
Oh, okay.
You?
No.
You have nothing.
This topic.
TDP says about everything. You say something wrong, he's going to be like, motherfucker.
I know what he says about. He says about people that he thinks, we think he should like, but he don't like.
I didn't know that one. You know what do you mean by that?
Yeah, well, exactly. like if somebody, he doesn't like someone, right. He's like, man, why you don't like him, man? What's wrong with you? He's all right.
Oh, so he says, why are you trying to make me like someone that I don't like?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't let it go that far.
Huh?
I don't let it go that far.
What do you mean you don't let it go that far?
If you bring the person's name up, I'm gone. So.
Right. Yeah, if he don't like somebody and you try to put that person in the mix, he ain't having it.
Yeah, but I think that's, I mean, I'm like that too. But the difference is I'm not going to have, not the difference, but I'm not going to even entertain a conversation.
To the fifth degree.
But I'm not going to leave, though.
Oh, he's
TDP out.
He out. He only wanted, if somebody's on the show and da da da, he shut down.
Let me ask you this question on the same line. How do you feel then if you know someone has been talking, you know, bad about you and then they try to come by and be cool?
Can you handle that?
Because if it's somebody that you fuck with that they talking about, then they don't know that's a secret bond that's out there. That's some people that'll get at you. You don't know that part.
Right.
So you just let them talk and be on their
own. So they don't know that you know. Exactly. I got you. That's what I'm saying. To me, that's, you're more powerful that way.
They just be in the mix and thinking they're good to go and all that.
You're using them for whatever you think. You're not even using. You're just like, okay, if you can get a gig or whatever, you just.
They don't know what you know.
Right, they don't know what you know. Mm-hmm. Like, I know, like I always tell the story, I ain't gonna tell it again. I'll just say, I know the comics that were back in the day at Fat Tuesday that used to talk about me in the back. Mm-hmm. To this day, I know who they are, you know? So I treat them accordingly.
It's hard for me to hide stuff when I know somebody don't like me.
So what did Eddie Griffin say about you?
Eddie was always good. I like Eddie Griffin.
Eddie Griffin's always been cool. Eddie Griffin's always cool.
But very talented.
Yeah. I was trying to come up with I'm doing the Image Awards Saturday, and I was trying to come up with a line. He came up with a funny line about, I have to do this woman's 80th birthday. Mm-hmm. And I was like, well, I can't charge somebody that's 80. He said he don't care. He charged.
Yeah, charge her $80.
He charged. And
I ain't gonna wear a suit.
I'm not gonna wear a suit. And he said,
I said, yeah, we'll save it for the funeral.
Yeah, I was hanging up.
Hey, mom, how much time you think you got?
That was funny.
No, just bring it hanging up.
You stupid. And then they ask you, what's this for? In case she don't finish the show.
For the next show.
For the next show.
That's cold.
And I would like to be paid in advance.
Yes, the layout show.
I thought that was hilarious. So I was trying to think of a line about saying that Katt Williams and Monique will be receiving, we have a new category called the Katt Williams and Monique Award. What would it be?
Yeah. What would it be?
Anger management.
Give us some thought. Huh?
Anger management.
Anger management award.
You just bringing that suit that's the joke right there.
No, not this is for the.
Oh, they just talk about straight Katt Williams and
Image Award.
But Katt and Monique are cool though.
Yeah, so no, that won't work. I'm saying the people out there, the Image. Well, hey guys, welcome to the Image Award, 55th Image Awards. So it's obvious, guys.
But I don't.
Oh no, we have
give
a
F
no
award.
Yeah, we have a new award category. What? And they just build it up. You said, and the presenters tonight will be
Katt Williams and Monique.
Yes, Katt couldn't be here tonight, so we got Club Shay Shay.
Okay, I just
got to
think about that.
Well, the setup is that it's an award in their name, so it's like,
right.
Don't get on our shitless award.
Yeah.
I know you can't curse.
Yeah, so we have to come up with that. Look, I'm Louis Dix.
TDP.
Dannon Green.
And what's the name of the show?
In a Man's World. Tighten up your belts.
Yeah, so let us know if you've been sensitive. 323-815-4204. I mean, you know, you're not sensitive.
For what?
So, it is.
You're not gonna read the other part of that.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
She on your ass.
Shit, no. So the other part, which she added, Oh, she's just a, only.
I thought it was in the man's world though.
Yeah, but sometimes what happens? I'll send her stuff, and she does. I mean, it's cool because I go too long. My stuff doesn't make sense.
Okay,
she makes it make sense.
Okay, go ahead.
So I give her that.
You got it.
The stuff I send her, she's like, what does this mean?
Female part of the show.
Well, it's because my stuff doesn't make sense. So so she breaks it down. That's why I don't send it through the.
I got it.
The group chat.
I sent mine. Did you get mine?
I did.
I sent mine directly to her, so I'm not embarrassed.
I send it too.
So, okay. Have you, are you a crier? Have you ever cried in front of a significant other?
One time.
And how did that come out?
I mean, it was.
And what was the reason behind crying?
I had a death.
Okay, in the family?
Yeah.
In your family?
Yeah.
And you. The person came to you, or you were.
Well, it was just, it was not right in front of me. I was on the phone.
Okay.
And then, and I was talking about the subject, and then I did. But I wouldn't cry in front of a chick that I'm really dating. Or
so
like
you
that.
Were on the phone with her?
Yeah.
With her.
Mm-hmm.
And you start crying. What did she say?
Well, they all say, it'd be okay. No, it ain't, bitch. You ain't here. You know what I mean?
So what was it, a boo-hoo cry or you sniffing?
No, I mean, it was painful. It was a close family, relative. Yeah. So, I don't really, when I get emotional and mad, I'm usually by myself.
Do you cry or do you
look? I do. When I cry, like what happened to when I was younger, it's a deep cry for maybe 2 or 3 minutes and then I'm almost like, and then I get mad, like, fuck it, I'm good. Mm-hmm. Now that's how I used to, even when I used to get beat, I'd be mad first. I mean, not mad, but crying. Then I'm like, you know what? It is what it is. Because I feel like when someone's going at me like that, or I mean, not it, but when I'm crying, it's attacking something within me. Mm-hmm. So I feel like it's just, you know what? It is what it is. Ain't nothing going to change. So you might as well just keep it pushing.
Have you ever faked crying in front of a girl to?
Yeah, when I got caught cheating.
Yeah.
I did. Her name was Tracy Johnson, aka Tracy Jordan.
So wait, how did that?
But I'll be real. And any man here to say, TDP Logger say, ain't no way no man in here never cried. I got caught cheating.
Nah, you on y'all on this one.
Oh, hell out of here, TDP.
So
you
what?
Know it.
Now, go ahead. What happened?
No, because I got caught cheating. And she was like, look at that. I can't do it. It was a cause. I'm sorry. I feel for you. She's like,
her pussy was so wet.
Hey, TDP, but she brought it though.
It took
about 15, 20 minutes.
That shit was fire.
I said, I just ain't mean. I was in college in Iowa. It's just not. That's not.
Was it a white girl?
I banged the white girl.
Next question.
Oh, wait a minute. So it was to a black girl.
I banged the black girl, but I was crying. I mean, I banged the white girl, but I was crying to the sister.
Oh, the sister bought it?
I was dating the sister, but I banged this white girl.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to bang her.
Shit.
I didn't, TDP.
I gotta have this snow beast.
It was my 21st birthday, and she tried to crack on me, and I wanted to leave. She was dating my boy, and I said, "No, you dating Vic? Nah, like this." And she said, "Okay." She was always on me, and at the end of the night, I had about 4 or 5 of these.
Oh,
I went looking for her.
God, it's you.
I went looking for her. Mm-hmm. And you know how I got caught?
What?
Her roommate snitched on me.
That so nigga was over here.
No, but what happened was I was tagging it, and when I walked and left in the morning, her boyfriend was at the door.
Yuck! The girl that you tagged.
Her boyfriend was at the door. Vic.
What'd you say to him?
I looked at him.
Hey, Vic.
But he looked at me. I looked at him. Now, I ain't gonna lie. This is middle golden love time. So I think he was thinking. But then he came back to my dorm.
You let a nigger in your hole?
Oh, no, he was a brother.
He's a brother. Okay.
He came back to my dorm.
Same thing. He said
the
same thing.
20 minutes, about an hour later.
You in Iowa, nigga?
Cause my birthday was on a Monday, and so that Tuesday I didn't go to class. And he came to my door. I knocked on the door, and he said, "I said, who is it?" He goes, "It's Vic." So I was like, "All right." So I opened up the door, and I went to go back to sit on my bed. And he said, "Man, yo, man, why you bang my girl, man? Why you fuck her? Would you want me to bang Tracy like that?"
Mm.
So I stood up. Tracy went to St. Ambrose. I went to Mary Cross. It was right across town. So I stood up. I said, "Man, look here." And he said, "See, look, man, see, I got a gun, nigga."
Mm.
And then I sat back down, and he had a gun.
You're cute.
Oh, God. Yeah. And I said, so I just said to let him talk. And then he said, "Fuck it."
Oh, you let him talk.
TDP.
Oh, you let him.
So then he said, I never told this story live.
Yeah,
I can tell.
Did I tell him a time ago? Yeah. And I put the gun down. No, he put the gun down.
Oh, you put it down.
No, and he said, "Come on, Dan, let's just do it." Like that.
You're so nervous.
And I said, "Vic, look." I said, "Look, man." I said, "No, man, because if you start getting me, I'm going to reach for the gun And if you get me, if I get start getting you, you gonna reach for it. I said, man, my bad, dog.
I thought you put the gun there.
No, no, he did. He had the gun. And then he picked the gun up and left. And then I found out, like, a week later, though, 2 weeks later, it was a BB gun. It wasn't even a real gun.
So, all right, now, so who told your girl?
He did.
Pure right, so comedy.
Because he went to Ambrose with her.
All right, so he went and told your girl. Your girl called
and
you.
And then Tracy called me, and she just, and I knew it.
Oh, so you cried over the phone with her?
No, no, Tracy came up.
Okay, what she said?
She called me first, like, Dan, how could you? I said, Tracy, look. She said, no, I'm not. I said, come and just come and talk to me. And she came, and then that's when the acting, that's probably when I knew I was going to be an actor.
Yeah.
And she came in.
She came in, and she was like, how could you? Why would you do that to me? And where I go to school, because they went to school together. I said, well, look, Tracy, I'm sorry, baby. You know, I feel, I didn't mean to do it. It's my birthday. And then I just started going into the.
You did not say it's my birthday.
Well, it was my birthday the night before.
I ain't never heard that one. Hey, babe, look.
Don't hurt me on my birthday.
It was my birthday. I had to hit it. I mean, everybody does that on their birthday. You know?
I get a pass.
It was my birthday.
It was my birthday. You got to let me get one shot of pussy.
Lou, did you say you were
gay?
Doing the warm-up for Image Awards?
Yes.
When is that?
Saturday.
Well, I want to send a big shout-out to Sheena, because she was nominated for an award.
So she cut our laughter for this?
Yeah, she's my Facebook friend.
Oh, Sheena. Oh, congratulations. Yeah. Sheena, our producer.
Yeah.
Who's okay. Sheena?
Wow, never mind.
That's the one that you...
Oh, the dark-skinned sister?
Yeah, the dark-skinned sister. Oh. The sister, yeah. The beautiful waffle sister.
The one that thought I was looking, I didn't know who she was?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Tell her happy birthday.
Who can really make waffles
birthday?
And chicken.
I said she was nominated for an NAACP Image Award.
Congratulations.
Oh, what did she do?
Sheena.
She did Sheena, I forget what year, but she was the editor-in-chief of XXL, and they did this iconic photo called... The Greatest Day in Hip Hop. It was sort of like a takeoff of
the musicians
the
in
jazz.
New York.
Yeah.
Oh, so they always on the stage. Yeah, I remember.
Can you pull that picture up?
Yeah, I'll try to pull up both.
So is that why she get one now?
So last year,
well, I mean, she went way back to New York.
And I'll say this too: the photo has been traveling in museums and everything. So last year, they did a podcast series. On Audible about that day.
Oh, okay.
And it got nominated.
Wow.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
I wonder how many of them guys or women are still alive.
From the jazz photo or the
hip-hop
photo?
No, not the jazz, the hip-hop photo. That would be really interesting.
I don't know. Sheena, you should call in to give us the facts on that. I'm not sure how many artists were there that day, but it was a lot of them.
But speaking on that, which rapper... Over the years, did you guys feel worse about passing? Outside of Biggie and Tupac. So let's take with
Colin. I wasn't really into rap. You know, one person that I love listening to his song is Heavy D.
Heavy D.
You know.
I met
got
him
nothing
before.
But love for you, baby. Yeah. I just love, you know.
What
plus
a
I,
dead have.
What about you, TDP?
Scholar Rock.
Damn, you took mine.
Scholar Rock.
Bro, he took mine. That's what I was going to say.
I don't know who that is.
He was a DJ. And you know what happened? He
ODB.
Was at, oh, you know, Scott LaRock was actually an educated dude, had a job working for the city.
Working for a shelter.
Yeah, he was a welfare office and got caught up, called in by one of his boys who were having beef with someone else. They called him. He goes over there, and he got shot.
Yeah. Murder.
Wow.
Yep. And it's funny you say that because I have a homeboy from New York, and his name is Andrew Scott. I met him in grad school, so I always nicked him. Yo, what's up, Scott LaRock? I always call him Scott LaRock. Mm-hmm. Wow.
That was funny. Cause
that's funny he took my
at the
God,
show
damn.
Last night, I was asking people in the audience, the warm-up, about if they had a nickname. Mm-hmm. And, you know, what was your nickname?
Baby Dank. It is.
Baby what?
Baby Dank.
Why? What is that from? What's
because when I was a kid, they used to call me Dankston. it's just something in Philly. And actually, my name was actually on the cement... Right on Felton Street.
Oh, really?
They just call me Dank, so they call me Baby Dank.
Mine was Wally Gator.
Damn.
Because my nose is so big from the cartoons that came out of the water. Wally Gator. What
from
was yours?
From the swamp. Teeter.
Teeter. Well, did you have a nickname, boss?
Light
Peaches.
Oh.
Never been to Georgia.
That's something, boy. All, yeah, girls who are named Peaches.
That's
boy.
Messed up.
They have good booty.
Always cute, boy. Girls named Peaches, you're like, mm. I forgot what.
You're nasty.
JoJo was code threes. She said.
Why are you snitching?
Oh,
again.
She made me some nice tea.
And hey, code three.
Chat room, call us, let us know, or for say what? It in the chat room. What's your nickname? Some nicknames you have. Okay.
Ask Corey. Did Corey talk yet, POTUS?
Now you did always not have something funny. Have to you say. Ever cried in front of
the police? Yes.
Stupid. Yes. You never cried in front of a girl.
For what?
I think you topped it. I'm with you on that.
I know you cried.
No.
Yeah.
Hey, and I didn't appreciate. Hey, I read that on.
Good.
No. What's his name? George Holt.
Yeah, who's George Holt? Yeah, he's
cracked.
What
he said? That little chump said. And I know he copped.
Oh, wow.
But he said that it was like Peaches, like Jeff and I made up. It was like Peaches and Herb, and we know who Peaches is.
That's fucking good. That was a good one, George.
Yeah, that was a good one. He said, yeah, we know who Peaches is. That hurt my feelings. That was funny.
So I have the photos. We'll start with the first one.
Hurry up.
Yeah, put this in the
Art Kane.
That was the jazz photo, and it was called A Great Day in Harlem.
Man, that's
in 1958.
Beautiful. Wow.
And this is the one Sheena recreated for hip-hop.
Wow.
And it's called A Great Day in Hip-Hop.
Yeah.
Now, here's the question. Were they all New York artists, or were those artists from around the country?
There was, I think E-40 was there. It was some West Coast.
Okay.
It was some West Coast
now,
rappers
Now, question
there.
Is, did they have a performance anywhere putting them all together?
No, it was for specifically for that photo.
Because
Gordon Parks shot it.
Shot that photo?
Gordon shot the hip hop.
And she put it
photo.
Together?
Yeah, Sheena was the editor of XXL at the time.
Wow. How old is that picture?
The hip hop picture is probably about 25 years old, 20 years. I think it's 25 though.
Now, okay, staying on that. Since we're staying on that, because we're talking about the hip hop and the jazz and everything, I sent Poetess a piece, I felt better with once you learn something, because we're always talking about the generation and how they're gyrating and
gyrating,
you know, doing that whole thing with
twerking
and all that, and how it's disrespectful and all that. Then right. I found a piece from 1938.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if you could pull that up. 1938. And look at that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I saw that one, yeah.
That's 1938.
Yeah. But you got to remember, back then, those were showgirls. It was different.
All I know is she's doing it.
Yeah.
I don't know how much different that is.
He had to put her in a box.
Yeah.
I was trying to save her.
I don't know. It doesn't look like twerkish.
No, that's what I'm saying. That was a showgirl.
That first
that's
part
respectful.
She's doing,
yeah. I think even back then it was still tasteful.
Yeah.
Like
today is
not tasteful now. Burlesque and all that.
Okay, because that was from Michelle movie, the movie called Swing.
Yeah.
1938. Yeah. It was.
It's almost to the point now, you almost get tired of turning on your Instagram because you know you're going to see somebody's ass, somebody. I mean, it's just.
Okay, well, let me ask the woman here, is there a difference in what you saw? And now, here's the thing. It got me excited.
Of course.
So, I was like, it looks so
like
natural.
Like balls excited?
So does the new stuff get you excited? The new twerker?
No.
Why?
That well, looked
you,
more natural.
You tell me what's the difference.
Thank you.
Oh. That seemed more natural. And plus, they were saying that kind of dance, I was talking to someone else, that kind of dance came from Africans and
it's tribal.
Tribal. Yeah. You know,
yeah,
and she's tapping a little bit. She just looks so free and
yes.
So. And look how the other women are looking at her.
Yeah.
But even back
at
then, at least she was mostly dressed. Look at the stuff they wear today. The tights all up in their crack.
Let them live. Right. Jeez. This guy wants to protest.
Disgusting. It is. It's disgusting.
Well, I know. I played.
I
mean, I
played
play
it
a
again.
Few times.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
I ain't talking about her. I ain't talking about her. She looks. She's beautiful.
Yeah, yeah. She just.
She's a queen. Great.
So you wouldn't hit Sexy Red.
Who is that?
I mean, I wouldn't crack on her. I hit her.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Okay. No, so
what's
I mean,
the difference? You wouldn't crack on her. What do you mean?
Come on, you know, street turn crack. Like, well, I wouldn't try to pull.
Right, right, okay.
So, but if she said, "Yo, I'm," Dan, you want to get busy? I'm like, "Yeah, sexy red, let's do it." But I'm not gonna, sense? I'm not gonna holler at her.
Oh, but you'll take it.
Oh yeah, I mean, I'm gonna hit it.
Oh, okay.
That's nasty.
Yeah, it is, but I'm still hit
it. Ew.
And she said,
"Oh,
look,
yeah." That's oh, a- see, when I said I want to hit a black woman, now it's ill. The only one I want to hit is a problem. That's a shame.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm not saying ill about.
I am.
Sexy rat. I'm just saying, just how you would just with a stranger.
With a stranger, she is. She's a stranger. She's sexy rat.
You're a fucking whore.
A man whore.
I get my balls dipped though. Say what you bump.
Oh, wow.
Balls get dipped.
Dipped where?
Dip. They get wet.
Ranch dressing.
Oh,
that's
bitch,
cold.
That's nasty. TDP.
Oh, was, my God.
Yeah, that was.
Where are you, Jeff?
Yeah.
Call back.
He's with the plumber.
Yeah, he's with the plumber. Okay.
Getting plumbed.
It's time for this already.
Oh, my God.
Still no warning.
25% of the country. That is your warning.
I love you too, Poetess.
I want to dedicate this this segment to my homegirl that just passed away, Boss. Rest in peace to Boss. She was the first female rapper to sign to Def Jam. I met her back in the day when she was working with Def Jeff because he was also my producer, and Jeff produced, I think, one of her biggest hits, Deeper. And so rest in peace to Lachelle Marie Laws, a.k.a. Boss.
Rest in power.
How old was she?
54.
Wow. Where'd she die from?
She had went through many years of like ailments, like kidney problems and stuff like that. I think she was trying to get a
kidney transplant.
Mm-hmm.
Can we get a photo of her?
Sure, I'll bring one up in just a second.
Yeah, she was dope when she first came out, but then everybody, it was like with the whole Vanilla Ice thing, and her was like they weren't real because you know she went to private school. So
oh, so they judged her?
Yeah, they was doing that. That was early in the game. That was before social media. So. But she was dope.
I mean, knowing her, like, personally, she was pretty close to her persona in person, I think. So, but.
That was the moniker they put out on her, though.
Yeah. Everybody think people that go to private school is soft, but right. It's not like that.
Right.
Private school, they go there for a reason.
But that was
cases.
Early in rap.
Yeah. Yeah, shit is worse, though.
You have real credibility back then. They
yeah.
would.
Yeah, yeah, back then you need. Now it's worse. Yeah.
I remember when PM Dawn came out and KRS-One jumped on stage and punched one of them.
Threw him off.
Yeah.
Why'd he jump on stage and punch him?
Because they were talking shit.
Because he was fake, a fake rapper.
Yeah.
Is that why they don't like Drake? Like
Drake is dope.
Yeah, but DMX didn't like him. A number of people didn't like him.
Do you consider Drake hip-hop?
I consider him music.
I don't know. I'm not. I don't know the difference.
Yeah,
I really don't.
I met him. Cool dude.
Who, Drake?
Yeah, we were doing the BET Award. Yeah, that's when he had the cast on
he
his
was
foot.
Nice. He was a nice guy. Cool dude. Too,
he seems like a nice guy.
Good yeah, music. I interviewed him for MTV. He was real nice. Yeah. He was a really nice guy.
Most people are nice one-on-one. Most people are.
Yeah, I remember one time because when so? I was doing interviews for yeah, I'm ignoring you, MTV, and they were like,
"That was funny, dude."
That was funny the way he so? Slid it in there. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Now I don't feel so bad. He gets everybody.
Right. I was saying MTV was sending me out to interview Lil Wayne. And they were warning me. They was like, he's wild, he's rude, so, you know, be careful, woo, woo, woo. But when I got there, he was the nicest person. He was like, pardon me, I have to take this phone call. He was just like so polite.
You know what's funny? You say that. That happened to me this Tuesday. I was playing in the WACP golf tournament.
What?
What numbers? And what numbers were they?
NAACP.
NAACP.
Leave that organization alone, nigga.
What is it? How'd I say it?
NAACP. You got me messed up now.
NAACP.
Hey, okay, NAACP.
You saying Delco, this nigga.
Damn, he still can't.
And you know who I played with?
Bless his heart.
And they said that he got a bad rap while he was in the league. He was in my group, DeSean Jackson.
Cool, from L.A.
Cool than a fan.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we actually talked about that. He said, do you, because I guess someone has, one of the guys said they didn't like Stephen A. Smith. So he said, do you believe that you cannot like someone before you meet them?
Right.
That's what he asked. And I said, well, the problem is if the perception is sold to the people and that's where everybody gets and no one gets to meet that person, it's a strong possibility that they may not like you. Mm-hmm. I said, you had a bad rap in the league. I said, but bro, I ain't gonna lie, my man, you cool in the fan. You know, and he was like, all right, OG. He cool
him up. Did you really say cool in the fan?
Yeah, I said cool in the fan. I'm OG, nigga. Okay. But there was DeSean Jackson was really cool. And then I met Kevin Garnett and he was the same. And I told Garnett, I said, man, I really ain't like you while you was in the league. And I didn't.
What did he say?
Do you think he cared?
Well, his response was funny.
What was his response?
Well, he was like, and why is that? I said, well, first, I'm a Sixer fan. I said, I went to Philly. He said, all right, I'll give you that one. I said, and then I'm a LeBron fan. He said, well, it's too bad on that. And it was just like, you know, because they don't like LeBron. Mm-hmm. And they laughed. Him and Paul Pierce, they do their show. And they did their show from the golf tournament.
Yeah.
But, you know, you meet people. I just think that you meet people. I know I've had that issue where people have perceived me a certain way. And then when they met me, it's different.
Cute. Well, we've met you, and we still don't like you.
Well, I'm not talking about this hateful group right here.
Go ahead, finish, please, lady.
All right, so the House votes to ban TikTok. What was it? 352-65, showing bipartisan support. It now heads to Senate, where they don't know, you know, it's still some uncertainty what's going to happen there. At issue is TikTok's Chinese ownership. Mm-hmm. U.S. officials say parent company ByteDance could hand over the personal information of 170 Americans who use TikTok.
170 million?
That use TikTok. The bill's opponents have raised free speech concerns. They also say that TikTok has taken steps to safeguard the data of Americans, but they said if the Chinese government says turn over this information, they're going to turn over the information, whether they say they won't or not. But there's a lot of money in TikTok. This is my personal opinion, is they're giving them an option to either sell to an American company or to disband. So I think America is seeing all this money that TikTok is making, and they want their share. So why would they make them sell TikTok when there's other ways that I'm sure China is spying on Americans?
Well, you know the other reason why has been getting issues. Hmm. Because they say that the algorithm that they show in China
is different.
Is always positive for the kids, showing them what they're doing, showing them how to do things. And they said in Great Britain or England and America, we always get all of the
smut. Ignorant.
Yeah. So that was that on top of what you're saying.
Yeah, so the Chinese, that was one of the their TikTok reasons. Is educational for kids.
Yeah, like it's
they
no
trash.
They show
people doing science projects, mathematics and stuff like that. It's nothing like the American version.
Yeah. So that's why. So what you're saying in terms of making money is true, but I think some people may look at it, and I look at it sometimes. I mean, I'm on it. Is we're buying ignorance when they're selling intelligence. Mm.
That's not good. Yeah, I'm not a TikTok person.
Well, a lot of people make money on TikTok, not just doing viral videos, but there's a lot of like TikTok shops. Mm-hmm. Where people are selling stuff on there. So there's a lot, I think, of money involved.
Market.
Yeah.
So it's funny because one of my older clients today called me today. She goes, is it over? TikTok shutting down? She thinks if TikTok shuts down, she's not, she doesn't have to do a podcast or whatever she thinks that, I don't know.
Do you think one of the reasons too is that because of the greed of America, it's like people are making money, but the government may not be making money off it? Because, you know, like Cash App now and some of them other things, apps, they're trying to use it as tax forms. Like you have to, at the end of the year, they're going to actually tax you on what money you've been getting in if it's over $600.
Yeah.
So do you think that one of the problems with TikTok is the fact that maybe our United States government isn't getting the bulk of that money? Because if people are making money, but are they being taxed on it?
I don't know. I mean, how are they receiving the money, though?
Well, a lot of times when you... Well, you know what? I don't know. I
mean, yeah, because...
yeah, no, because I was thinking Cash App, but I don't know. Yeah, thank you, TDP. Hey, TDP, you didn't give me a lot of...
Way to bail out.
Thank you.
Ejected out of that one.
Plane going down.
Well, I don't know. I don't know.
How many people in the chat room would miss TikTok if it was banned USA?
I wouldn't miss it at all.
I like TikTok.
Instagram. I miss Instagram more before TikTok.
Every time I walk in the room, Code 3 is laughing at that stuff. She
at TikTok?
Different.
Because
yeah,
it'd be everything on TikTok.
Yeah. She cracks
you know,
up.
Today's stars are TikTok stars.
Yeah.
Like the girl who did the 51 episodes of Who the Fuck Did I Marry? She just signed to Creative Artist Agency.
And you know why, though?
Why? Because they'll make a series out of it?
No, because... She
got
just,
over like 100 million views on that.
Yeah,
stuff.
But she was been on it. Well, what happened was she went on the show.
You know this.
I do know this. She went on Tamra, and she was complaining about
Tamra Hall.
Yes, she was complaining about who she married and talk about some other stuff. So Charlamagne the God had heard about it, and he went without seeing the video, said that sounded like some fatback issues.
Right.
And then everybody went in,
uproar.
And then it was an uproar. And
what
then,
is fat back issues?
Fat
she's,
women.
Oh, she's fat.
Yeah,
oh.
Is fat she? Back. Yeah. So she married someone.
So basically, she did these 50 something episodes on TikTok explaining how she met this guy, dated this guy, married this guy, and he turned out to be a fraud. He promised her all these things. And it never came, like he was saying he's gonna buy her house. I'm only on episode 10.
Only.
Wait a minute. How long?
I don't
were
know
the
rest of the story.
How long were the?
They're about a good 5-10 minutes each.
And she's telling the story. So
she's telling the stories in parts. So it builds up to whatever.
So she told him one day, edited it down. Every day. She talked for 2 hours one day and said, "You know what? Let's cut this motherfucker up."
Yeah, so it would be interesting.
In it, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, they were getting like five and six million views an episode. So it'd be interesting if that guy came out and did his version.
But as soon as Charlamagne the God said something, she got signed by CAA.
Yeah.
She'd been having the followers,
right?
But it wasn't until, you know.
So he pushed her over the top.
Yeah, well, because everybody started, most of the hits now were hits about, you know, you're fat shaming, you're body shaming, right. And then of course,
but she's,
you know,
fat.
She's bigger than a motherfucker. You know what I mean?
She's speedy size.
She makes Speedy look small.
I mean, Speedy likes big women. That his size?
No, she's bigger than Speedy size.
And now she
caller. Are you big?
You know, I had to call in and check y'all panelists is incorrect, sitting up there strong and wrong next to Lewis.
She said strong and wrong. Cee
Moore.
Strong and wrong.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Cee Moore, how are you?
I'm doing great. Congratulations, Lewis.
Thank you very much.
You're out there helping the children.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it was a great, great, exciting time. I enjoyed it.
Now you got to get in the ring championship and get on that knee championship, praise God. Mr. Dannon?
Yes.
Hello, sir.
How are you, sweetie?
What Charlamagne said, everybody, is that when he heard Jess talking about the situation, gentlemen, and Poetess, he said it was giving big back energy.
Mm. Big back,
that
fat
was
back,
before
yeah.
she went on Tamron Hall. But she talked about how bad, and then some other girl made a comment about her appearance, a VP wouldn't date her. You know what I'm saying? So she did these comments about her appearance hurt her feelings.
Yeah.
But it wasn't just Charlamagne's comment. that got her signed to CAA. Come on, Dannon. Mm-hmm. You in the industry. You think that's going to get a big firm like CAA well, to sign her?
Let me say this,
can
though.
Can she finish?
No, she asked me a question.
Jeez.
Let me say this, though.
You're getting your ass handed to
I can, I shut up, CDP. This is why I was. This is what I would say. You asked the question. Being in the industry, a lot of times the industry doesn't know anything about, especially sometimes when it comes to black people, until it is brought out to the forefront. Yeah, that's right. So like you said, and thanks for correcting me, it was on Tamara's show.
She's black?
She's black. Okay. So,
Tamara Hall.
So Tamara Hall. So once that show, but Tamara Hall, who's married to a white man, by the way. But y'all women ain't got no problem with that one, but it's okay. But anyway, once it was on that show, you're absolutely correct. But then CAA came and signed her. She been had a lot of followers. It's not like she had followers 50 million one day and they go, ooh, let's sign her. They obviously didn't sign her until this type of publicity came out, whether it was good or bad. You have to give me that.
Mm. And then this was the issue, Poetess, that people, now Charlamagne did say he hadn't seen her. He was just listening to the story and that it sounds like big bag energy.
Mm-hmm.
The issue that a lot of people took to it was, Charlamagne, your wife doesn't have a big bag. You cheated on her. You just started being faithful to her for the last 6 or 7 years of your marriage. DJ Envy, we all know he cheated on his wife, Gia, who's a very beautiful woman. So what they were saying is for Charlamagne to make that, and he's always talking about mental health, and that hurt Teesa. Her name is Reesa Teesa Lou. That hurt her feelings. Now, you can't be a proponent of mental health and talk about not disturbing people's peace, and you're on a big platform such as The Breakfast Club, even though you didn't see her. It's almost like you're saying bigger women are more desperate. Mm. Like smaller women or the quote-unquote preferred women aren't getting lied to, cheated on, and aren't desperate for men. Look at that chick that was out there, Rick Ross' fat ass. She was all on, you know, social media talking about, oh, you know, what he had with the pretty V is different. And then she was in the doggone gym and his music came on and her whole face cracked. She had to cut off her live because they'd already broken up. Rick Ross at the basketball game sitting front row with another preference.
Okay,
you know what
I'm saying? Can we say something, Seymour? Here's the issue. Just like we talked about earlier, you went and attacked every single dude because of what one man said, which was true. So just because those guys had cheated on their wives, or whether they did allegedly, that doesn't still mean that she didn't get signed off of the fact that nobody knew who she was in terms of CAA, because people can say what you want. One thing I know about this business, you could be funny as fuck in Oklahoma, but if LA don't know you, they don't know you. So until she got that publicity out here, she wasn't signed with CAA. And after that happened, you have to admit, she just got signed with CAA.
But I don't know when she got signed.
I'm just telling you, she just got signed.
I'm not saying this because of Charlamagne. She did. A lot of women connected with her story.
Of course.
Dannon.
Yes, ma'am.
A lot of women are coming out and talking about how they have been lied to, too. She's not alone. And it has nothing to do with her fucking size. Mm. That's the point.
Okay.
Right. I will say this.
All her videos are going viral. It's like 50 video or 52 videos, Poet. They're about 10 minutes long. I did 1 through 3, and I was over it. I was off of it. I'm like, yeah, I'm not that nosy.
I only listen whenever I have time, so I'm only on 10. Yeah, I'm just interested. Sure, I haven't gotten the spoiler alert yet about the video, but some of the stuff I'm listening to her and about how she was, I didn't want to tell my friends. You didn't want to tell your friends because you knew. Women know when they're in a fucked up relationship. They will deny it. They will act like, you know, they don't see the red flags. I've been there. So.
After a couple of weeks, she moved to me, and I'm like, oh, hell no. I'm like, yeah, I'm off there, because I already saw her culpability. And she does take accountability of the things that she did. You know, I'm a Christian, and we were staying together, and this so let's get married. I'm like, girl, no, ma'am. But, like, I just want to share this part to the gentleman. Y'all, he will be talking to his brother every day. Oh, my brother said hello.
Yeah, I mean, some of the stuff that she was saying,
pretending like he's talking to his brother.
Yeah, my thing is, there were so many things that
she knew
in the beginning. You know,
bless.
Could I ask you one question, Seymour, before you go? So why could you just say something? Why do men seem to get the hit when, like Porter said, women are in these relationship? Now this this lady obviously knew that, you know, she was overweight. And this guy, I don't know if she knew he was with her for whatever reason, but why don't women take accountability for what they accept?
Well, if you watch the videos,
Dannon, she does say, you know, I take full accountability. She was just sharing her story. And a lot of women connected to it because they began to share how they were also like, but you're culpable as well, you know what I'm saying? But it don't have to do anything with her size. My point, when I say the part about, you know, being lied to, is Charlamagne's wife is not big. He's lied to his wife. He shared that he's lied to his wife. DJ Envy's wife is not big and not a big back. Yeah, they're married because their wives stay.
But they have a job to do. See, you getting on them. Their job is to comment off of what old girl said. So that was yeah.
Yeah, but you,
so, no,
but
you hold on for a second.
Said, though, without the big back comment, but, though, Dannon, you missing the point.
No, I'm not
he's
missing.
He's trying to imply, act like bigger women are more desperate. That's not true.
He said no. He said it sounds like big back issue. But still, the point
TDP.
Is...
Let Dannon know that these slim bitches out here desperate, too.
Desperate as a motherfucker.
They want to lie. They want to buy the lies.
But Cee Moore.
Damn, you desperate bitch.
Cee Moore, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that, Cee Moore. I'm just saying that it seems like...
Damn!
You're getting on Charlamagne the God and DJ Envy, but they have a job to do. And see, so if they're talking about it, unless you don't want them to say anything... Then, I mean, what'd you say? Well, I'm saying that because...
No, she was saying that they were just because they were implying, without seeing her, that...
It was big back issues.
Right. Big back energy. And whatever they were saying.
Right. And what made him mad was that he was correct. That's why they were mad.
But it could just as well...
No, but I'm saying...
...have been any woman.
But in this situation here... let's keep it 100. In this situation here...
I'm going to let you get back to your show. All right.
Okay, but in this situation here, he was correct.
Thank you,
and that's why people are not going to get upset if he was wrong. But because he was correct that she was a big woman, that's why he caught the heat.
Is this in your segment?
We're talking about it now.
All right.
All right.
Well. A Georgia judge is expected to decide on the fate of Fani Willis.
She's going down.
Tomorrow,
what?
With the Trump election interference case. So,
what's your assessment, P?
I don't know. It's a hard one. It's a hard one. I mean, she should have had her T's crossed and her I's dotted because she's dealing with these people. They're gonna go in and investigate everything on her.
Once Trump said her name, but
if she didn't break the law, and like the judge said himself, he said, Judge Scott McAfee has said Willis's relationship with Special Prosecutor Nathan Wade could result in their disqualification if evidence shows an actual conflict of interest.
And
or the appearance of one.
And there was. Last week when I called in.
What's the conflict of interest?
Again,
though?
I said before, the conflict of interest is it's okay to date while you're working. But the problem in this situation was they were dating before she got the case. And because she was dating before she got the case, she hired him. And now she's paying him out of taxpayers' money to prosecute Trump. Because they were going on trips and he was paying for it with his credit card, it looked like and it assumed and it was shown that he was paying for trips with the cash that she was making, thank you, TP, if I'm wrong, and correcting me wrong, that she was given. And I told Speedy this last week. Everybody kept saying, you hating. I'm telling you, if she would have came to me, if she would have came out and said, look, yes, we did date before, but we had no idea we was going to get this case. Then people can look at it differently. But she lied. And she went in and said, well, you know, we went on trips, but he paid for everything. Then they started getting her. And then she started, even right now, now she's got this other situation where she's saying, well, the numbers were put in wrong. Yeah, that's what happened, came out today. Mm-hmm. So it's so many different elements coming into it. If she would have just came out, I believe POTUS, and said, we did date. It was before we got the case. Once we got the case, we broke up. Mm-hmm. And that was it. Then what can they argue? But when you start saying, well, the data from the towers, cell towers, doesn't matter, now you're bringing in a whole bunch of other stuff. Because now you're saying, you just put YSL, you're putting these boys in jail for using that same technology, but now the technology is no good for you. And that's the issue. And I've been saying that. And everybody thinks, well, at least Speedy, that it's not going to happen.
You think he cried when they broke up?
Okay, so the other thing is there's a campaign going on. In fact, I got a press release about black women feeling that they are trying to humiliate her in court. Mm.
She, okay, the whole I'll let you finish. Go ahead.
Can gorilla you? Gripped. Did you guys? Here's the
what
video.
Was the whole gorilla grip?
Here
about?
It is.
Oh, wait, she used name. She that was never mind. I'll let her do it. Go ahead.
What was the whole what was that about? I saw that.
Hold on. I'm about to play the video.
Which is 928-444. Which is 928-444-3555.
What's the owner name of this phone?
The name that would appear on, say, a Bluetooth device is found on line 32, which is Gorilla Grip Pussy Pal.
Now, see, that's just ugly. That's ugly talk.
So, wait, what mean that was a code or something?
Yeah.
That was a code.
That was the name I guess Nathan had in his phone under for her.
Yeah.
Well, Gorilla Grip?
Yeah.
Which means tight poo-tang.
Yeah.
That her stuff was a tight grip.
Gorilla,
that's nasty.
Boy.
That's nasty. That's nasty.
You don't know, you don't know Gorilla Grip?
I heard a Gorilla Grip pussy.
That's nasty. Are you serious?
Where you get it? From the gorilla.
Now everybody looking at her like, oh, she got that gorilla.
Hey,
not
grip.
The monkey. I'm telling she you, got man, the gorilla.
Man, look. I've been following this case.
If they, how embarrassing is that?
Yeah.
I don't hear it.
That's in court.
That's embarrassing. I mean, my God. That's
now, you're the district attorney
that's embarrassing.
Of Fulton County.
Everybody that she put in jail is like, oh, really?
Yep.
That's, really?
Thank you. That's what I'm saying.
Really? You put me in jail for that? Really?
And your name is
I mean,
Gorilla Grip.
Could you imagine her?
Line
I'm,
one.
I'm on gorilla trial grip. And she's asking me questions. I'm sorry, Gorilla line Grip, one. I didn't hear you. What did you say, Gorilla Grip?
And that's what they're saying now, POTUS, is that, to your point, because so much has come out and so much stuff is, how can she keep this position?
And you know Trump's going to run with it.
He going, yeah, his lawyers.
I'm surprised
he didn't the dogs on her.
I'm surprised he didn't repeat Gorilla Grip.
Okay, but you do know a black man turned him in.
So let's my question is, in your phone,
have we ever had a Gorilla Grip in our phone?
Do you have a nickname for particular people in your phone?
I got a honeypot in my phone.
I got a snow bunny.
You got it under snow bunny?
Mm-hmm.
Lewis?
I'm going to check. No, mine's, no, I don't have a.
Aww.
I used to have one for my ex.
Which was what?
The past.
Oh.
Damn.
The past.
She didn't call up the past. No.
Past. Yeah, so that was, I had the past. Wow.
I think I got the snow bunny in my.
I'm embarrassed to say
this. I took
to
it out. This, I took it out.
Oh, here,
come on,
guys,
let it out.
Quiet. It's going to be a good one.
Someone told me they have me in their phone under mic check.
I was expecting more.
So anyway, TDP, what you doing
oh,
tomorrow
you don't
night?
Get it.
Let me change Poetess's name.
Yeah, mic check.
What
does it mean? What is it?
I gobbles don't get it. The mic.
Oh. Oh,
okay.
Oh, Mike.
All right.
They got okay. excited.
I didn't all know right. what that meant.
Jeff, do you have anybody in your under your phone?
Earring nose.
That's earring nose. That's yeah, I don't have. I mean, everybody's got, like, I got son, daughter.
Yeah.
I got mom.
What a
dad.
Nasty stuff at.
Black boy.
Right. Yeah. Teeter, who do you have?
I got wet mama in my phone.
Wet mama.
Yeah.
I got high booty in my phone.
Not the black mamba, the wet mamba.
High booty.
Years ago, a girl
I'm
got
very
mad
creative.
At me because I had her name Mr. Mr. Gaines.
That's gay.
You had her name in
so
there?
So you were Mr. trying to hide
yeah, so you
were
trying to hide that number. Yes, yeah.
And bring out your homosexuality at the same time. Okay. Tricking yourself.
Wow. But see, but Code 3 can go through my phone.
Okay.
There's nothing in my phone.
She got the password?
She can go through mine, too.
She got the password.
Oh, that's good, Lou.
She got the
that's
password.
Good. That's good, man. You're trustworthy.
She got the password. She can answer my phone.
That woman grabbed my phone. I'm stabbing her.
But she's all about plain view. If someone's in plain view, she gets to see it. If you don't want to see it, you can turn it over.
Plain view doctrine.
That's what it is.
Hey, can I ask you guys a question? Does that bother you if you go on a date and a woman does that to you?
What?
Like, you on a date with her and she's on the phone and then she goes, yeah, so anyway, like.
Well, I'm not on a date with her.
Well, no, yeah, I'm asking you, though. No, okay.
I'm not on a date with her.
I'm not on a date with her.
I mean, okay. I, you know.
And so, Like,
it is in a man's world. I'm asking men questions. You jumped in just
so I can't be in the conversation. No, because
the way because the way you about to say it was about to go well. I felt the energy.
See if she stayed on the phone.
Felt the big back.
Yeah, I felt the big back energy.
Yeah, we're gonna make you large,
Lou. That was good. Let that marinate, Lou. That was good. Let that marinate.
All right, go ahead.
All right, so Elon Musk allegedly reneges on his deal with Don Lemon over a tense interview that he did with him. So Don claims that after he did this interview with Elon Musk that got intense because he was asking him, I guess, the hard questions. And so now Elon says he does not want a partner with Don Lemon after that, even though the show is still going to air on the Twitter or the X platform, but he's just not going to get, you know, he's not going to go through with the partnership. But Don was like, well, you talking all this free speech and you are this person that believes in this strongly, but now you have an issue with the interview I did with you. So Don says, his spokespeople say, Don has a deal with X and expects to be paid for it. So he may be trying to sue Elon Musk for...
He got, what, $24
million from, Elon
from CNN.
Elon
giving
him money.
And now Don is just... Now Don,
they say he got fired on his day. They say, how you get fired before you... That's what they were saying. Like, how you get fired on your day off?
Don got some back energy. All right.
He got some light-skinned back.
Back energy.
Tight booty energy.
Wow.
Well, I'm not saying
that. That's the Poetess Report.
You're stupid.
Could you get one more?
Playoffs!
Sorry, Tita, what'd you say?
Could you give us one more story to get that taste out of our mouth?
Okay, shout out to my girl, Regina King. She has a new movie coming out called Shirley, which is about the late Shirley Chisholm that's going to be on Netflix March 22nd. It chronicles the groundbreaking run for president that Shirley Chisholm ran in 1972.
A Republican.
Really? Mm-hmm. The film, written and directed by John Ridley, highlights the audacity and boundary-breaking campaign that marked Chisholm as the first black candidate to seek a major presidential nomination. Her sister, Regina's sister, Raina, is the executive producer. So
is Regina playing Shirley Chisholm?
Okay. Yeah.
But she was tall, though, wasn't she?
Was she Shirley? I don't know.
I thought she was.
She's a tall woman.
Yeah, Regina's kind of, well, it doesn't matter.
I mean, that made the camera work.
I've seen the trailer. She looks like she's portraying her pretty good. Okay. So.
Well, she can do that.
You ever notice that a lot of the black stars, it seems like all our movies have to be biopics a lot lately? Like, it doesn't seem like we're making just good films. It just like everything has to be, you know, the Emmett Till story. Something back. All of these dudes are putting their money into those type of projects or people.
Oh, well, what about American Fiction?
Yeah, I haven't seen that.
I haven't seen that.
Everyone talks
Jeffrey
about how good
Wright
it is.
Movie. It's good.
Is it good?
Yeah. Okay, good.
I enjoyed it.
Okay.
All Issa right. Rae's Shut in that it. Down. And they also won an Oscar for best screenplay. So.
Eric Alexander's in it too, right?
Yeah.
Girl from Living Single. Mm-hmm. She's so talented.
I heard, she's
very
talented.
She's good. So all that's right. good. All right.
Playoffs?
When you just talk about practice, we sitting here, I'm supposed to be the franchise player, and we're in here talking about practice.
I wish one of your guys had children before I could kick them in the fucking head and stomp on their testicles so you could feel my pain, because that's the pain I have.
I wish I was 50 years younger and I'd kick your ass.
You won't do shit with this guy.
Oh, we look like the damn Bad News Bears.
You need a new intro. I don't like this.
Cheetah Sports Tick, I have a couple, but I'm going to stay with that one. Right
what,
now.
Really?
Yes.
That's boring. It doesn't do anything.
Well, I'll leave. March Madness is about to begin.
Yes.
Selection Sunday.
Hey, first of all, you should have started off with Harvard Westlake winning back-to-back state championship.
I was saving up for the... Never mind.
All right, go ahead.
Whatever.
Okay, go ahead.
No, let's do you.
No, go ahead.
No, don't touch me.
I want to do March 1.
Don't touch me. Good. Harvard Westlake won CIF Boys Division. No, y'all in a certain section. Y'all in at the top. With y'all.
Open,
yeah. The Open. You guys won the Open. Back-to-back champions, so definitely congratulations.
Congrats, Lou.
On that, Coach Lou.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, so some more important news. Go ahead, T.
If I was really interrupted. And that vow for March Madness in the tournament. Yesterday, the Jayhawks lost to Cincinnati in the Big Ten tournament. Mm. Yeah, they got with them. And let me see. Cincinnati was ranked 11th, and the Jayhawks were ranked 6th. Hut 2, Joe Flacco signs a one-year deal with the Colts. Mm-hmm. 30-year-old former Brown quarterback will be Anthony Richards backing up. Mm-hmm. $8.7 million with $4.5 million guaranteed for Joe Flacco. Raiders release quarterback Jimmy Garoppolo.
Did they?
Jimmy G and slot receiver Hunter Renfro. Freeing up $19 million in salary cap. So, Danny, what do you think about that?
That's your second team.
Raiders.
I think it was a good move. Antonio Pierce. That wasn't his guy. Mm-hmm. He didn't like him. And to the point where he started a third stringer over him and got the guys to rally around him. I think Jimmy just never, like once he left New England, man, and I think the joke with him was what porn star Jimmy? Remember he was dating?
Jimmy G.
Yeah, and it seemed like he never got that stigma out. And then when he went to the Super Bowl that year and he kind of choked. When they had a chance to win.
He choked.
I was trying to be nice. But, you know, he choked. I just think after that, he never, because he threw the ball. I mean, he throws a pretty ball, but he just never became the winner that everybody thought he was. And he got fat contract when he left.
You know what, huh? Ravens released wide receiver Odell Beckham after one season and pick up Henry, the running man.
Derrick Henry, yeah.
That might get them over the hump.
They got the running man right now.
That might. What do you think, TDP?
That might be that. That's what they need. But you still need a wide receiver.
You need one. I think they were missing speed. I think the same thing with the Eagles. They're just missing real
missing hands. Them dudes are dropping the ball.
Yeah, yeah. And then the young boy fumbled. They relied on him a lot for a rookie. Flowers. But I just want Lamar to get there 1 year.
Absolutely. Had 3, Russell Wilson to the Steelers. Mm. One year deal. And our announcer, Jack Fleming, he retired, so we traded Jack Fleming for Russell Wilson as quarterback.
What'd you think about that?
I love it. I wanted him to go to Atlanta, but since we got him, goddamn it, let's go.
That's what you still I think it's okay. Here's the deal, though.
He keeps his number 3.
He keeps
the quarterback.
That. But you have to not really be wanted for a team to eat $85 million.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to be like, yo, fuck it. Like they said, Sean Payton was just like, ain't give a fuck. Yo, I don't want him.
Yeah.
The problem I have with Russell Wilson is, not I have, but what has been said is, they said that he's not the best team, even though he's a really nice dude, they said he's not a team. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Is it because he's square to people?
Well, the TDP? Broncos owe him $37.79 million.
Which is why y'all only signed him for $1.2
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Slick motherfuckers.
1 year deal to prove yourself.
Yeah, but I'm saying you don't have to pay that money as well.
Exactly. Yeah, I know he's still winning.
Biting the cost.
Caller!
He's got Sierra.
Yeah.
Yo.
Tim Sports Ticker.
Hello.
Hey, is it Dannon?
Hello? You're calling in the man's world. Dannon has his own home phone number.
Hey, what's going down, Lou?
Hey, what's up?
Hey, I'm a little late listening to the show, but I was listening to Dannon talk about the Fani Willis situation. I think he's got that all wrong.
All right, cool. Who's this first? Clear it up.
Oh, my name is Clayton.
Clayton?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. Not Clayton.
How you doing, Clayton?
Hey, Clayton, what's up? Where are you from, Clayton?
I'm up here in Seattle.
Okay, right, thanks for calling.
Don't start clowning Seattle, Lou.
No.
You're classic about that.
No, man. I like Seattle.
No, your weed is great. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's great coffee house.
Seattle's good. You a Seattle Seahawks fan?
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, much respect. You a family man?
12th man.
Oh, yeah.
All right, married, kids?
I got a little girl, yeah.
All right, cool. Okay. You got a little girl. You have a daughter?
Yeah.
Okay, you got a wife?
No, no, no. I'm a single dad.
Okay. Oh, so you're raising a daughter.
How'd you kill her?
She's nine.
Nine. And you just
with a nine? With a 9mm?
With a 9. I got the clue.
So you're raising her on your own?
Yes, sir.
Well, good for you. Now, do you have a girlfriend that comes over, or just you and her in the house?
Wow, Lou.
Well, no, like I just want to know. I'm just trying to get a picture of how many single men,
where's
single fathers
your sock
talk
drawer?
To, who, I mean,
this oh,
is,
no. Yeah, I got a lady, but, you know. Go ahead.
But that's your daughter that you're raising, and is the mom in her life?
You know, it's complicated, but no.
Okay, yeah. Good for you. How'd you get custody?
Man, you know, her mom enjoyed them streets more than being a mom. So.
Is your mom, no disrespect, is she white?
No.
Okay.
Well, you know, respect to you. That's what I wanted to set up.
Absolutely.
Respect to you. So
thank God.
He did the right thing. They always talking about brothers are not doing the right thing.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And there you go. Okay, go ahead. Continue.
All right. Now, the Fani Willis thing. Where am I wrong?
Well, here it is, Dannon. She wasn't dating or she wasn't messing with Nathan Wade until, what's that, November 22. Mm-hmm. And her dad confirmed that when he was on the stand. She was dating some dude named Deuce, who apparently is some type of radio personality down there in Atlanta.
What's your name again, brother? What's your name again, brother?
Clayton.
Go ahead and finish before I dispute what you say. Go ahead.
There's nothing inappropriate about what they're doing, and there's no conflict of interest. You know, it looks a little funny, but people with that high pressure of a position, they're going to date who they're around. And so, you know, they're going to get together, and they got the money to take little trips, but like the one brother said in the Senate hearing, you mean to tell me you guys are bringing this this motion or this hearing for someone who makes $200,000 a year to go on a trip for $3,500?
Okay, Clayton. Clayton, you sound like a real nice guy, but I'm going to just do this quick. First of all, you're right. She was dating another dude who happened to be a DJ, and I believe he had gotten I think he got killed actually before she started.
By the gorilla grip?
No, I don't know. but let's go ahead and dispute your time zone. You said 2022. Well, you know they met in 2019. That's the argument, right? You know they dated.
Right. And,
So they dated in 20.
No.
The argument is 2019 that they dated. They started dating in 2021.
No, but Dannon, that's incorrect.
I'm going
they met at. They met at a judiciary conference.
Okay.
In 2019. That's
yes.
The first time they met, you know, Nathan Wade was hip to what was going on.
Okay.
But the gossip and the speculation comes from that cat, Terrence Bradley.
Who was his partner? Nathan, right?
He got kicked out for some inappropriate a situation with a woman in the office.
Right.
He started gossiping.
Was it gossip or was it
one
truth?
No, he started gossiping to one of the defense attorneys, and then when it got serious, now he want to clam up and act like he didn't do anything.
Well, I beg to differ. Thank you, Clayton. But you have to go to YouTube, and you have to look at the whole thing. I looked at everything. And just real quick on that.
Brother.
Clayton. The reason that Terrence told was because he was kicked out of it, and he was upset. You do know he contacted the Trump's lawyers. Mm. You know that, right? The Trump lawyers people didn't contact him. He contacted them, and when it was asked questions,
right,
look at the text messages. They asked him about the time, and he said, "Absolutely, you need to go." I watched this whole thing, so
right.
I'm just telling you, brother.
And you really think he was telling that white woman the truth?
Do you really think that they're going to these as high profiles a case like this?
Answer the question.
No, I don't think he's lying. I think he told them the truth. Why would he lie to them knowing? See, this is here's what you're not thinking on.
Mm. Jealousy and anger is a motherfucker. Though,
I'm not, yeah, you're right. But here's the point. He gave that information believing he would not be called to testify. That's what happened. So he thought that he could call Lewis and go, Lou, this is
right.
What went
he
on.
He's going to impugn that brother's character, lie on the DA, get some attention and possibly a little bit of money.
Mm-hmm. But if you believe that man,
but he didn't know the depths in which those defense attorneys would go to make these claims. You got to understand, Dannon, we're talking about a RICO case with 15, 16, 17 different defendants. You mean to tell me she put together this scheme to charge the ex-president with a RICO charge?
See, you're talking about, no, look,
let,
you're
let
talking about Trump.
Let him finish.
Don't
finish.
It's not finished. Okay, but
go ahead, go ahead.
With a RICO charge, just so that she can benefit off the little bit of money that he was making, he's making way less than he would be making in private practice. Right. And we're talking about little trips to wine country.
Little trips.
Come on.
Napa.
And then, you know, so, the one.
Hey, Dan. Dan.
Mm-mm.
Who's that?
Jeff.
Oh, shit. Damn. What's Yo, up, Jeff?
Dan, and my question to you is, her fucking way, what does that have to do with Trump interfering with the election?
See,
what does that have to do with it at all?
I'm gonna answer your question.
Okay, well, first of all, hold up.
Well, hold up a second. Hold up. I think my man that testified, I think he did it out of retaliation because he got fired.
Okay,
that's what Clayton has said. But Jeff, you need to say hello to Clayton first.
Yeah,
just because
you interrupted him.
What's up, Clayton? How you doing, man?
What's going on, OG?
All right, so let's just answer your question. This situation here has nothing to do with Trump. This situation has to do with them trying to avoid getting to Trump. So when Bradley called,
she prosecuted Trump.
She did, Jeff. She did not prosecute Trump. They're trying. This is the case that they're trying to avoid.
No, Dannon, he's been indicted down in Georgia.
He's been indicted.
Indicted is not being prosecuted. That means you're just the charges, bro. You talking about? I know. Okay, anybody here knows.
I don't know everything that
TDP,
you know.
Let me ask you a question. If you're getting indicted. Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean that you're prosecuted. That means the charges are brought against you. Right. Yes or no?
You're just on the record.
You're on the record. So you guys are up here. You can't get your emotions out of it. He just got indicted. Mm. What Trump people was trying to do is say, look, Louis Dix is not valid and eligible to run this case against me because he is sleeping with the female lawyer that is supposed to prosecute me.
Tampering.
And
tampering.
That is not a conflict of interest.
It is if you're taking campaign money.
Not per Georgia law.
Okay. Give me a call next week. And then when the decision's made, you tell me.
It's going to be made tomorrow.
Okay, well, tomorrow, tell me why that decision was made by that judge.
Hey, Clayton. What's your
Join
baby,
our
girl,
Facebook page.
What's your baby girl's name?
Yeah.
Ava.
What is it?
Ava.
Ava. Well,
that's a nice name.
Yeah, it's a beautiful name.
I don't like it. Change it.
how long did it take you to get be able to do her hair well? You got that down?
Oh, man. Maybe 6 months to get comfortable braiding the hair.
Okay, so you can braid her hair and all that?
Yeah, but you know, Lou, we grew up in the hood. Sisters was braiding hair on stoops and so you think it's easy, but man, when you got big man fingers,
big back fingers.
Hey, but listen, so Clayton,
the phrase.
Thank you for calling.
Thank you, man.
Much respect to you, man.
Call in next week.
Hey, Dannon, I appreciate it, bro.
No problem, bro. Thank you, man.
Hey, there's a single dad.
I like that. See how our conversation was, and then he thanked at the end. We were cool. That's not supposed to be.
No, I don't think he's cool with you, but
but he acted nice.
No, he's
professional.
He's a man that's handling his business. I know that.
Now this nigga here.
Hey, look who's back.
Yeah,
hey, what's
him?
Up?
Look at him. You look like a big.
You look
like your neck broke.
Yeah, you look big back. what you and the plumber doing something?
Yeah, big
what's
back neck.
On? Yeah, that's better.
Yeah. I'm handling business. I'm gonna show you where you can set up shop at.
Oh, now that's funny. Now that is funny.
Give us a tour.
All right. So where would my
hold up? First of all, this was Lewis Corner when he used to come to the dime when the lights would be out.
Oh, okay.
Snitching.
Lewis Corner right here.
I see his Vaseline still there.
Yeah, this was before he was with Code 3. So.
Way to cover it up.
I would just stand there that's all, and watch Jeff deny people in.
Nope.
You got to wait, my man.
Yeah. Even though ain't nobody in the club.
Oh, no, it was packed. It stayed packed. That's why I had to stand in that corner.
Right, where's the stand at, Jeff?
Yeah, where's the stand going to be?
Where's the what?
The hot dog stand.
What are you doing, crack?
Well, I'm going to show you right now. Here we go.
We waiting.
It's going to be out front.
He done walked the back way.
Right.
He done turned around. This guy here.
So this is where people will line up right here. They come out right here. This is my neighbor's next door right here.
Damn, he got you down the street, dog. You crazy.
I ain't even outside of
the club. Yeah, you ain't even outside the club.
I'm gonna clean this area up right here, and then you have a perfect location right here where you can sit the stand, the hot dog, make that money.
I love it.
Yo, you need to right slap here. The shit out of him for that.
I love it.
He got you four blocks down the street from the club.
Let's have a cold opening.
All right, I feel you. So
look how far you got to walk back.
You don't want the smoke going into the. Jeez.
Yeah, you think it would have been right outside the joint.
So they don't want the smoke.
Oh, he
going
to talk
inside.
A big shit about you. Hey, yeah. Who's that
my
guy
man down the street can help
you. Yeah, he got some dogs.
Yeah, you go down the street, the hot dog man. Yeah, he's going to cope. So listen, we're in the middle of TDP sports segments.
I already wrapped.
Oh.
Teeter, you had a couple videos.
Yes, I did.
Are you going to watch the videos, Jeff, and stay with us, or are you out?
I'm going to stay with you all, yes. All
right, cool.
Fuck.
Dude, we was hoping this nigga didn't come back.
All right, well, hang in there. Okay, go ahead.
Iverson draws Jordan now. Watch
out. I used to do the loop all the time. Yeah.
Big, nice play, but watch out. It was Iverson down to break him down. Michael trying to stay with him here. Very quick move. He goes to left, his right, his left, his right, and he comes up with a jumper. Knocks it
down.
Tell
me about the little guy's crossover.
Very quick. You try to pick and choose which direction you want to send him. I figured that he wanted to come back to his right hand, but you know, he keeps the ball real low. And he's small, and he's certainly closer to the ground than I am. So, I mean, his quickness is...
That's the anniversary of that move.
Wow. Hey, you know what's crazy about that? The whole setup. You ever hear the video? The whole video when you hear Phil Jackson go, Michael. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, it's like it's cold switch shit. On. Like, yeah, like yeah. Somebody else was doing it, he go, Michael. Michael's like, I got this motherfucker. And no, Allen said, nope, you ain't got me.
He was real.
That put him on the block. Was that the shot, you think?
Yeah.
I mean, he's been on the block. You know what I mean? Yeah. But, like,
yeah,
that was a hell of a crossover.
Absolutely.
Was that your video?
Yeah, I have two more.
Oh, damn. Okay, sorry.
Oh, yeah, I saw this one. I like this one.
Motherfucker, did you just put your hands on
hands
me?
On my head?
No, I'm a cop wide receiver, nigga. Hit me!
I like the video, the audio too on it was nice.
Mm-hmm.
But my man, but he even had the football stance, receiver stance.
Right. Look at him, he like, damn, the cop got me.
Now I gotta go to jail.
Now I gotta go to juvenile. I'm supposed to be in school.
My man laughing. That's, so that was a good cop. That's right. Neighborhood cops.
Yeah.
They from the neighborhood.
They're going to arrest him later on.
Well, he know he can't outrun him.
Yo, he sure enough can.
It won't allow me to play the third one, Teeter. Sorry.
Oh, wow.
And you just want me to just sit here and take
no,
that?
No, we just move it on.
Somebody get the view on the phone. I'm sick of this.
We need an upgrade.
I had a video I wanted to show, too. I didn't send it to him.
I think I have my, yeah.
Go ahead. All right, continue.
Whose segment is it?
It should be mine, wouldn't it?
Hold on, I gotta find your video.
Who made the sound effect?
What?
Who just said?
I did.
That was jazzy. Yeah.
Oh, Jeff Ballhead.
What's that on the? So, Jeff, you still there?
We're glitching.
Yes, sir.
Dannon Green spits the truth, ideas, and stories.
She emphasized spit too hard for me.
With Dannon Green,
nigga, you is ugly.
I
don't know why she don't play that.
All right, real setup. Last week's championship game, LSU, South Carolina, the brawl. Go ahead, Poetess, please. I was prepared.
Hilarious.
Wait, hold on. Let me see if there's sound.
Okay.
This was a good game, man. It was physical from beginning to end. All right, right near the end, you know, you got some emotions. They're running high, a little push there, but then you know, big sister comes blah, okay. But then little brother comes out of the crowd, and he says blah. That's a big girl, man. That dude right there, that cop right there, saved your life.
Okay.
All right. That's he saved your life. Emotions running too high.
Thank you. So, on the shade room and other.
Platforms.
Thank you, TDP. People have been kind of agreeing with her brother jumping out of the stands and giving him props and blaming the tall girl for also Kim Merkley, the coach, on pushing the young lady down. Mm-hmm. So my issue was how people perceived the coach and perceived the player from South Carolina. And the reason was, if you saw that play, it was near the end of the, near, you know, it was the timeout after the foul. The person that got pushed down, that player, I think her floor, I don't know how to pronounce her name, Flora, whatever she is, the rapper girl.
Your story.
Yeah. She pushed a player. And then, so when she pushed the player, that player's teammate came over and pushed her. Mm-hmm. So everybody is saying, well, the brother did right by coming out the stands. But I'm saying, no. You got 11 other teammates. And why would you get out and go into the court from the stands? Because now, and people say, well, he was just being a big brother. But I said that was opening up a can of worms. Well, what if happened if the other girl's family would have saw him jumping out there and saying, oh, he's attacking, you know, my sister, my daughter, whatever. Then there's an issue. So I didn't know if you guys saw this play, and I wanted to get you guys' opinion on what you thought about the situation with that. Who was to blame? Because they're trying to say Dawn Stanley took the high road by saying that's not what we're about. But Kim Merkley said, well, if she'd have pushed Angela Reese, it would have been a different story.
She would have fell harder. Angel Reese would have fell harder because mm-hmm. that girl's a big girl.
Big girl.
Now, first of all, her brother didn't have no business coming out on the stage, mm-hmm. coming out on the stands.
I feel the same.
That's not your place. Your sister can handle herself. All right, like you said, she got other teammates. That's why you got arrested. Because mm-hmm. you shouldn't do that.
So, I'm sorry, I missed that point, and thank you for saying that. That was the argument, and thank you for saying that, Lou. In the shade room, they're like, well, he should have never been arrested. I mean, and, you know, and you could see that they was trying to make it about race at first, but both players were black. You know what I'm saying?
No. You can't come out on the stands. That's not your place.
And then you touched the other player.
Yeah.
That's why he got arrested. He didn't get arrested for jumping onto the court. He got arrested because he touched the South Carolina player.
Once you saw her, you back down anyway. Because you were little. I don't know what your little tiny behind coming out there. You just selling wolf tickets.
And what do you think about what? Well, go ahead, TDP.
I don't care.
Okay.
Nah. So,
yeah. No. I mean, and you know, everybody's like Dawn Staley. She's from Philly. She took the high road. She said this is what she's supposed to say.
Right.
Kim is, you know, I mean, come on.
She always says what's on her mind.
I mean, come on. Kim is Kim. That's why she. That's why they undefeated.
That part.
That's why they. That's
well, they got lucky on that jump shot.
And look,
that
who
was
hit
big.
It.
Yeah. Look the big girl hit it.
Yeah.
So she's okay. So let me ask you, Lou, being a coach, she has to sit out. I think the entire game next one or the first half.
And I don't know if it's like football. No, she has to sit out the whole game.
So would that affect their run, or is it just that it would affect the SEC championship type stuff? No, that was the championship game.
So she'll sit out the game.
Or the first NCAA game,
but
right?
It won't be against a high opponent because they didn't have the
16.
Thank God.
Wow. Sonia Mills from Sonia. Sonia, I'm sorry.
Damn, it's your story.
Sonia. Well, that could be Sonia, too.
It could.
That's how it's spelled.
Torrance, California.
No, it's that Sonia, man. Come on.
She enjoys reading, dancing, and working out.
Oh, I would love to work out with that.
They all say they like reading. That's some bullshit.
Yeah, she's beautiful. She's beautiful. But nice, now, is the color, one leg, the right leg looks darker than that?
I think it's the light. It's probably the light that
she's under the shade.
Yeah. And then it's the light off of the, when you shoot photography, you got that backlight.
Cool teeth. She got a little hair.
She got a nice breast.
Mm-hmm. She got a little hair.
Yeah. Where is she?
Nice smiles. Where's she from?
Torrance, California.
Ooh, you think she still lives around here?
I hope so.
Now, you figure she's what? She's in her 50s.
I wouldn't give.
What year is this, Lou?
70s, I guess. So she's got to be.
She got to be in her 60s.
Yeah.
If it's late 70s.
She still don't look like that, I'm sure. She don't look like
that. Oh, wow.
Damn, Lou.
That's racist.
I mean, look, I'm sure she ain't got
now, if women are going to call in saying, we don't age well?
They don't. They just do that with you.
Yeah.
She don't have big back energy.
Oh, that's not big back energy?
No, that's old energy. Old back energy. Thank you.
She was cute.
Always.
Very.
Yeah, I mean, most of them have been cute, so now we're going to start putting up some ones that are not as cute. See what people are.
Let me ask you this question to both of you guys. Is it more important for you to date a woman that's cute with a nice body or ugly? I mean, cute without having a body or ugly but has a body? Which one would you accept?
I think it depends on the age. Once you reach a certain age, you just want the beauty to be inside, mm-hmm. you know, which radiate outside.
Oh, my weenie. Yeah.
Radiate. Stupid. On my weenie. I don't care how old you are. Come on, Lou. So you're saying... If Cole 3 had a terrible body, you would say,
wow,
but she's so nice. You know, well, nothing that looks.
Use her.
I'm sorry. But she looks nice. She has a nice body. Cole B has a nice little body.
Cole B.
Cole 3. Cole 3.
Cole
She's just a, you know.
He wants her, though. He wants her.
She's just beautiful. She's just, you know.
He waiting for you to get caught slipping.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
All right, we got to wrap up. But before we go, want to remind everybody to donate to the show.
Thank you, Jackie.
Yes, Jackie. Thank you so much to Jay.
Thank you, Jackie.
To Noel.
Thanks, Noel.
Sertsu. Ira.
Thank you, Ira.
Fred and Prime Primo. And our friend Bruce Smith just donated in the chat a nice $300. So
Bruce! Hey, Bruce. Thank you, Bruce.
When are you coming on the show, Bruce?
Damn.
Bruce is a drug dealer.
Thank you, Bruce.
I think Bruce is come on the show.
I'm happy I came in this week.
I'd like to ask Bruce some questions about the
what does he do?
Welcome Home Franklin.
Who's Bruce Smith for?
He's created Proud Family.
Yeah, oh, I didn't know. Dope. Wow. Thank you, Bruce.
I know now.
But I would love to talk to him about. I'd love him to call in next week to tell us about. I'm sure he's aware of that journey.
He can video call us.
Yeah, you can zoom in, Bruce. I'll hit you up.
I mean, what Proud Family was just. My kids loved it.
Yeah.
Why don't Bruce do an episode with us?
No.
We all play a character, like you know.
He likes everybody but you, Dannon. I'm sorry.
He's trying to have.
Told you not to say that.
He has a successful career.
I'm sorry. He didn't say that.
Oh, damn! Because I didn't even do that.
Leo Lawrence works with him.
That was great.
I'm gonna get Leo called.
Leo Lawrence works with him, but no, Bruce is a nice guy.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, he was at the cigar. Well, you don't get along with Guy, but he had invited us to the cigar lounge with Guy. You should make up with Guy.
Yeah, maybe your life would change.
So all right, but he could do that character and make him a Guy's character. Welcome home. But no, Bruce is it, and I hope because he has a beautiful daughter.
Thank you, Bruce, man. Appreciate you,
family man.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So he's.
It should be. We should be on it. We should have a segment.
Stop.
Yeah. Don't pitch.
See. Right. If you don't ask, let me tell you this. If you don't ask, you'll never know.
He does you say what animation, you want. Right?
Is yeah, this, that's what
the
I'm
new
saying.
Thing animation too, Lewis. The new project is in an animation.
Yeah, it's with the one that he's doing with what's her name? Who's the comedian that was had a talk show with.
Your
was,
story.
No, she's Ellen? With my man.
Larry.
She used to date
Tony?
No, the dude that don't like us.
Everybody?
Gosh. What's her name?
Wait, he don't like us or you?
On what platform, Lou?
It was they had the talk show. It was they were competing with the talk.
Old drama?
No, what's her name? She's a stand up comedian. Wow. Jeff, you there?
I turned him down.
Jeff,
are you there?
Yeah.
What's the girl's name? Has the talk show?
You talking about Amanda Seals?
No, it's the black girl who used to date my man that don't like us. Dark skinned dude that was a comedian.
Oh, Lonnie Love.
Lonnie Love.
Oh, Altuber.
You see how I got it? I called it. He said, dark skin dude. Only one black nigga in the whole. Yep.
That hates you.
He don't hate me. Yeah. I know Altuber. He my boy.
Yeah, he don't hate us. He hates you.
I don't even know why you fuck with Louis Little Dicks.
How's he doing? I haven't seen Al
in a long time.
Only time I see him, his picture pop up on Facebook. And I got to put the light on.
Oh, so Lonnie Love is messing with black people again?
I seen her on TV the other day. I thought about Al.
Yeah, Leo Lawrence, they're putting a little cartoon pilot together for her.
That's good.
Yeah, so it's very talented. So shout out to Bruce, man, as always.
Thank you, Bruce, man. God bless you, brother.
Man, just get off his jaw, man.
Why can't he never got nothing in his life?
I'm just happy I came this week.
You ain't going to get paid till next week.
Damn.
So,
are you a week in the hole?
Jeff,
that's how it works.
Anything you want to say? Because everybody's been talking over you.
Sorry, Jeff. What about the hot dog stand?
Yeah, sit up. Stop leaning like that.
Yeah, man. You're looking old, Jeff. You need to shave your head. That light shows all your.
Oh, my God.
That's better, Jeff. For real, man.
Wow, yeah. You all gray. What's up with that?
Yeah, Jeff.
What's happening?
You look handsome, Jeff.
No, don't tell me. Everybody says that when somebody's all gray.
Yeah. And when the other guys don't like him.
They call him Silver Foxes.
Oh, wow.
Silver Rat.
Could you turn him up?
Guess who I ran into and she loved it?
Who?
Robbie Reed.
Oh. Ah, where'd you... Now I was going to say something off. But
is she going to cast you in anything?
Where'd you see her?
At the Grove.
Oh, yeah. So okay. How is she doing?
Yes, it worked.
She's doing really well. She's like, Jeff, I'm really loving the white. I'm loving it.
Put me in something.
Oh, wow. Robbie Reed's a great casting director. She, yeah.
She is.
You know Robbie Reed, right?
Yeah, I know.
She ain't got that gorilla grip. I know that.
She ain't got that.
I know. Have you ever been experiencing gorilla grip? But yeah, we know you have, Jeff.
And she definitely ain't got no big back issues.
Yeah, gorilla grip is real. I did not know what that was. Gorilla grip.
How did they get that information, though? Because they wasn't giving out none of her texts.
On the phone. You don't know. You know the case. You've been following it.
I just said it. They weren't getting any texts out.
On the phone.
And also I want to say about that young lady making all those TikTok videos.
Yeah.
Can't believe everything, man. So much shit is scripted now.
Thank you, Jeff.
So much shit is scripted right now, yo. So, I mean, it's so much content. People not even trying to go to studios. They're not trying to even, like, have talks. This is their way of putting their shit out there, yo.
Yeah.
Yep. This is true.
So the whole thing is, you put something out there and you hope it pops.
Put a lie out there. Hope people cry.
Yeah. And with the other couple, Miss Netta and Charles. Have you guys seen them?
No. Yeah. No. What's up with that?
The whole thing is, you put a content out and you want people to talk about it. That's what you know. And she's got everybody on the internet crying. Talking about.
She has to be getting a deal for CAA to sign her.
Not really. They just signed her because they just in case.
Mm.
So yeah. what is the other one you're talking about?
Seen her at Netflix. Posted some picture where she was up at the offices of Netflix.
Yeah, everything is content now, yo. And you know, you really don't need TV anymore.
Well,
you got Facebook and you got Meta.
One of the true parts about it is you still have to have talent to continue.
Absolutely. Well, to continue, right.
Yeah, and to follow through.
To get through.
Like that girl that did the Trump impressions.
Mm-hmm.
She found out that she wasn't. That's all she had.
Yeah. Just like some comedians.
Oh, the girl Sarah something, right. And she would just
imitate Trump.
Yeah.
And did they sign her to something?
They signed her. She did. See? She hosted mm-hmm. Jimmy Fallon or something. Yeah. Or one of the
and then that was
days,
it.
Jimmy Kimmel or something and all that. And everybody realized,
come with something. She's young. So.
She's got talent, though.
Yeah.
But just not the kind of thing, whether she does or not,
your point is well taken. And that's what people don't want to admit. You can get in the door, which is what it takes, but it doesn't mean that's going to keep you in the room.
Thank you, Dannon. Those words of wisdom.
Thank you, TDP.
All right, I'm Louis Dix.
Oh, wait, I got to show you Charles and Miss Netta.
TikTok. It's going to be over for a lot of motherfuckers.
What is that?
Charles and Miss Netta.
What is that? Is that a woman?
Content.
Okay. Yes, exactly.
Oh, that's the
TDP.
Dude? Come on, man. That's the dude.
Okay, so they are TikTok stars.
Now, wait,
they
is that
started
a woman?
Out, trans- yeah. It's a transgender
person.
Gender, I okay. guess. He doesn't claim any of it, but they started out just her making meals for her husband. Now
that's her husband.
They're
married.
They're married.
You jealous?
So it started out with her making meals for him. I'll bring in the video next week. Now
you want some weenie and rice?
Now they're like, she made a song and now they're on tour and living like their best life just from doing something simple on TikTok.
Wait,
and she just BBL.
Huh?
She just got a BBL.
Who did?
Miss Netta.
Yeah, no, her husband just got fake abs installed.
Yeah.
Like, who?
So you got a big black lover.
So yeah, wait,
like Monique stomach.
Okay, help me out. So okay. they're on TikTok as husband and wife.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And so they're actually married.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't
they're
watch
married.
That stuff.
And people watch them. Do what?
They have. Give me. They get every time she posts something, she get over 15 million views.
what
yeah,
what
but
stuff
now
do they
post?
They,
just her fixing him dinner, and her tagline is "Charles, your lunch is ready," and then he'll
That's
come
disgusting.
In. He'll come in, and she'll have a
Has
big plate
him?
Of food. They kiss. Yep. They going around the country together.
Nasty.
I'm gonna cut your meat.
So I don't know their backstory though.
Big
but
back.
He's Miss Netta.
Big back energy.
Big back energy.
And she dresses like that?
Now she does. In the beginning she didn't, but now she is a self-proclaimed
beauty queen.
Social media icon.
I know what I'm going to do.
All you kids in acting school and theater, quit. You ain't got to do nothing. Just do something stupid.
Wow. Icon, you say.
Yeah.
Wow. So we want to thank everybody for watching. Be sure to follow In a Man's World on Instagram and Facebook.
I'll be over
Teeters
there.
Teeters on there.
Yeah. TB, I got to follow
you. Your, what is that?
Teeters Knocking.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw that. So you,
oh, I just see that. You ain't following me?
You haven't popped up yet.
Damn,
Lewis,
you haven't been on the
your...
page, Dannon, have you?
No, I thought I was on the Instagram.
What, you on the Facebook
page? Facebook
page. No, I never been on the Facebook. I never knew we had a Facebook page.
Good.
We tagged you and invited you on that.
Right. I don't think you did.
So what?
But can you do it again for me, though, Poetess, please?
No.
Hey, Jeff, yes. You made a point, Jeff. I just want to say I heard what you said, but we kind of talked over it. What you said well, you made a point that if they do drop TikTok, a lot of people ain't going to be famous no more.
They'll just move to another platform.
I mean, TikTok, they do direct deposit to your account.
That's what it is.
You don't get taxed.
So that's why the government wants it.
To your account, to what account though? Your bank account?
Yep, to your bank account.
No, the IRS know how much money you putting in the bank.
Yeah, but they don't tax you though. You have to do a 1099.
Right. TikTok doesn't tax you, but the government does.
Right.
And a lot of people are making, it's so many young comics now that's doing this. They lose, everything is a skit now. Any possible scenario that you can sit down and think of, they turn it into a skit. Mm-hmm. The dude, actually, and I told Lou about this, they did Lewis McDonald's bit at least 3 or 4 times now at a Wendy's, at a Burger King.
Damn.
Yeah.
Well, now
you can sue Lou.
Now we
got a hot dog.
You need to go to Shay Shay, yeah.
Let me do a hot
Hey,
dog
Jeff, thing. Is there any way you can move Lou a little closer to the club, though, instead of halfway down the street?
Got to let the smoke go down the street.
Lou, fine.
You don't give a
shit. I just want to say, people in L.A., come on to the dime. You have a great time.
What now, night is it popping?
Every night.
Now, will I have security around my hot dog stand?
Yeah.
I'll do it. I'll hire.
No, we have cones.
Yeah.
I get jacked.
Hold it. You still got your dick cones?
The dog ate him in the parking lot.
I bet he did.
There ain't no fucking going on in here.
All right. Fucking... We out. I'm Lewis Dix.
Fuck peace.
TDP. Danny Green.
I'm Lewis Dix.
TDP.
Danny Green.
Jeff Arnold.
Thank you guys. Peace out.
Peace.